Official speaking on the condition of anonymity told the Associated Press, "No, we didn't get it cleared. But we don't get our pop flies cleared either. And those go higher than this thing did." The flights ceased the next day. The agency bars commercial use of drones, no matter how seemingly benign. The lone exception is an oil company that has been granted permission to fly drones over the Arctic Ocean, and it took an act of Congress to win that concession. Unless FAA officials receive a complaint or chance upon a news story that mentions drone flights, they have little ability to find out about violations. The ban was further undercut this month when a federal judge dismissed the only fine the FAA has imposed on a commercial drone operator. The judge said the agency cannot enforce regulations that don't exist. The FAA, which contends it controls access to all airspace over the United States, has appealed the decision. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
According to members of the 1998 University of Virginia graduating class, Governor Jim Gilmore's commencement speech to them continues to be a deep well of wisdom and guidance even 15 years after it was delivered. Classmates confirmed that while friends at other universities heard from such figures as Jimmy Carter, Kurt Vonnegut, and the Dalai Lama, the inspirational words of Virginia's 68th governor continues to profoundly inform their lives and actions.
Whenever I face a dark moment in my life, I just think back to Governor Gilmore's speech, and it almost instantly puts things back into perspective. It's like he said, go forward and be successful and achieve your hopes and dreams and aspirations. All I can say is I hope I've lived up to that incredible lesson.
And in local news, a five-year-old figures he has about a year left of peeing at urinals with his pants all the way down. In other news, using the amount of toothpaste shown in commercials is a disgusting experience. A grizzled proofreader has seen it written both ways, and a cackling Warren Buffett burns his entire fortune in front of the nation.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can bring up whatever you'd like right here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Plus, we've got Skype. You can Skype into the show at username lrn.fm, so feel free to do that if you have that ability. With you tonight in the studio, Ian here.
Allie.
And Mark.
All right, so jumping right into the news, going international, we haven't really spent much time on the Crimea situation,
Crimea, yeah,
and or Ukraine, which Crimea is part of Ukraine. I am completely in the dark about this, Mark, but you've been doing research.
Right. Well, we talk about secession here on Free Talk Live on a regular basis.
Yeah, huge fan of that.
If any county or city, if any one person manages to get a little bit of news in the United States that says the word secession in it, you can bet Free Talk Live is going to talk about that story. However, countries... You know, places break off from countries all the time around the world, and we don't talk about them as much because we don't do really foreign policy that much on Free Talk Live. It's not that we're unwilling to, it's just that we don't know that much about it generally.
Do you know how it typically works when countries break apart from one another? Is there usually some kind of...
sometimes violence is involved.
Yeah, is there like usually warring over it, or is it sometimes just like, oh, you want to leave? That's fine. We weren't getting anything out of it anyway.
In some cases, it's that way. In a lot of cases, it's kind of like the destruction of an empire. Of course, when the Soviet Union blew up, many countries were created out of that. The Ottoman Empire, a little over 100 years ago, there were fewer than 100 nations. Now there are more than 200. Little more than 200, depending on how you count them.
That's a good trend, right?
It's a good trend. I like the idea of more home rule rather than less. And what Crimea wants, what Crimea wants is there's a bunch of different people in Crimea, right? There's these ethnic Tartars that apparently things weren't so great for them under the Soviet Union, and they obviously would never vote to move back to Russia. However, apparently the vote was something like somewhere between 93 and 97, I've heard different numbers, percent of people in Crimea that voted in this election wanted to go to the Soviet Union. However, the numbers look like more people than live in Crimea voted.
Right.
Whoa.
And let's not forget that there's essentially Russian troops in the streets.
Okay.
They took over the parliament building or whatever, you know, some kind of government building that I'm not entirely sure of, and put a lot of, that's a lot of pressure. You know, let's whip up an election here real quick, and oh, look, it's going our way. The ballot was really kind of sick. It was a vote between, you know, a picture of the Russian flag on one side, and the other side was the country of Ukraine with a big swastika on it.
Are you serious?
Wow.
Yeah, because apparently there's like some small minor party that has some say in the government of Ukraine, is a parliamentary say in the government of Ukraine that's like 3% or something, that's, you know, fascist neo-Nazi types.
So Russia designed the ballot is what you're
yeah,
saying?
Yeah, they did.
Well, I've heard accounts from Ukraine and people there that there's a lot of propaganda going on in favor of, you know, the Russian Empire.
Right. And Crimea is a very valuable place. So
why is that?
Well, they're right there on the Black Sea. It's a deep water port, from what I understand. And there may be some mineral issues, too. Mm-hmm. So neither Ukraine nor Russia wants to not have Crimea. Mm-hmm. It's a valuable little chess piece. And, you know, frankly, what I would be more interested in if I was Crimea is essentially being autonomous and setting up whatever alliances I wanted to set up. But I'm not an expert in the policies as to why they would or wouldn't do that.
Well, from the conversation we had with a guy who was living in Ukraine, the two sides down there, no one's talking about independence for Crimea.
No.
It's either stick with Ukraine or go with Russia, and blue team, red team, all over again.
Yeah, it's a lot like that. There's no doubt about it. So now,
and that's what people are getting violent in the streets, and the police are coming in, and there's all this conflict over which criminal gang will rule the country.
Right, and I think it's very disingenuous that people in Ukraine have any say about this. If Florida wants to secede, I'm not going to get out into the streets of Keene, New Hampshire, and set things on fire and kick garbage cans over. Let them go. It's
none of their
business.
A nationwide vote then? It wasn't Crimea?
No, this was Crimean. This was a Crimean vote. And that's the only vote it should be. And from
so then the rest of the country did not have a say.
No, but you can. But they're acting like they should. Mm-hmm. And Russia's been a real pain in the butt on this one. If this, it seems to me that the vote should be retaken without, oh, I don't know, Russian troops in Crimea.
Is it specifically Crimea that they're interested in, or
yes,
all of Ukraine?
Yeah, well, I thought the conflict like in all, Ukraine but was over which direction. Was it the whole country, or just like the northern,
eastern portion? There was a conflict in Ukraine over, you know, the president and that sort of thing. There's an ouster of some sort that I'm not entirely clear on.
There's been a lot of news coming out of there, and you know, I find it interesting when I hear things about it. But honestly,
I haven't spent days and days delving into this and getting, you know, completely up to date on it. But I guess from what I can tell from the news is that as far as a percentage of Crimeans, it would be larger than 50% that would vote to leave if they had a vote that, say, wasn't, you know, there weren't Russians in the streets and didn't have this weird ballot and that mm-hmm. sort of thing. And it kind of brings up for me, so there's a little chunk of land and 50% of the people, 51% of the people or whatever, want to move to a different geopolitical designation. And does that make it okay? And I don't think it makes it okay for the other 49% or 39% or 29%. And
people don't know another way. They don't understand another way. Even though there is a third way or a fourth way or a fifth way, you know, there are other options. They just don't see them. They're not presented to them. The mainstream media certainly isn't talking about them. If there is a Crimean independence movement, they're not getting press, at least not that we're seeing.
Well, what if Canada, who's involved in way less warfare and everything like that compared to the United States, wanted to take over New Hampshire? Would you not vote for that?
No, I wouldn't vote for joining another gang. I would want to push for the idea of independence.
Well, what if the other gang is a little bit nicer and less less
just
scary?
Because Canada doesn't do worldwide invasions very much. I mean, they have been involved in some of the allies stuff.
Yep.
But just because they're not at the forefront of that doesn't mean they aren't doing it, and also it doesn't mean they aren't hurting their people as well. I mean, they have drug prohibition there just like they do here, for instance, and they've got more gun restrictions there than they do in the United States, as I understand it, or at least it's certainly in New Hampshire.
Well, I think that one of the advantages is what Allie's asking here is if New Hampshire were to move over to Canada, and I'm not for that, but that it would it sort of breaks up the idea of the nation state to a small extent. If Crimea can move away from Ukraine because it wants to, supposedly, I'm talking about pieces of dirt like they have personalities. But if the people of Crimea can choose to have another political designation through the democratic process, it does show a certain level of independence for sort of smaller geopolitical designations. Right?
Well, then it would also mean that their taxes would go to funding the Russian government as opposed to Ukraine's government, right?
That's right.
I'm sure Russia is intending to get taxation.
Obviously, the preference I have in this situation, I don't live in Crimea, and mostly people don't care what I think, is that Crimea is in fact goes independent and then just sets up allies. I mean, Liechtenstein, Andorra, there's all kinds of, San Marcos, San Remo, I can't remember. There's all kinds of little tiny countries in Europe. There's no reason Crimea couldn't be its separate tiny country.
As you pointed out, it's got a great location.
Let's rent out that deep water port to whomever.
Right. I mean, it's essentially it's almost an island. I mean, it's surrounded almost completely by water. It's essentially the southern end of Ukraine, as you said, Mark, just kind of jutting out into the Black Sea. You're welcome to share your thoughts on the situation, because I know a lot more people know more than I do on this. But of course, Ukraine is not the only place in the world where there's conflict in the streets. Venezuela has also been experiencing
a lot of
large-scale protests. I've got a story about that coming up here in a moment. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Of course, you can take control. And don't forget, there's plenty of conflict here in the United States, including an 81-year-old grandmother, great-grandmother, as a matter of fact, who's been put in jail for something her animals did. We'll share that with you here in a few moments. 855-450-FREE. You can take control here on Free Talk Live.
I want to share something important that will not only improve your life, but the lives of many others as well. And all you need to do is drink coffee. I'm not talking about harmful store-bought or chain coffee. No, this is truly the best of the best coffee. We've partnered with Camano Island Coffee Roasters to offer BuzzBox. With every purchase, 10% goes towards our efforts to give the gift of human freedom by providing at least 100 microfinance loans via World Vision. So literally, just one cup at a time, you're having an impact and helping make a difference in the world. And one sip will have you buzzing to family and friends. To prove just how good it is, we're giving a free pound of coffee to everyone in the audience. All you do is cover shipping. Go to coffee.freetalklive.com. BuzzBox Coffee is organic, so it contains no pesticides or toxins. It's shade grown, so less acidity and no heartburn. It's top 1% Arabica grade and gives people the opportunity to own their own coffee farms. Join us in making a huge impact at coffee.freetalklive.com. Hi, this is Mark Edge, host of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the very economic engine that powers this country. With a printing press tethered to Washington politicians, bureaucrats, and central bankers, how can we put our trust in paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Come see gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold. With Washington, D.C. delivering more debt and printed promises, common sense tells us the future of the trend is obvious. Everyone listening should visit gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938. I trust Midas Resources for my gold, silver, platinum, and you can too. Again, I want you to have this book, and it's free. It's gold.freetalklive.com or 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
Immigrating to the Shire was easy. I was instantly plugged into a community of individuals who also care about peace, liberty, and justice, and are willing to do something about it.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at shiresociety.com. That's shiresociety.com. Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges start a conversation with your neighbor or your doctor or your family or your school. Now there's teachers and lawyers and business executives, and they all wear shiny badges and they all reject the state. Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges show the world that you reject coercion and aggression and oppression by the state. Shinybadges.com.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
This is Free Talk Live. Bring up whatever you want here, toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And we've got Skype. You can Skype into the show at username lrn.fm. Don't forget, you can join us online at freetalklive.com. We've got a chat room and a webcam. They're built into the same page, so you can just go to cam.freetalklive.com, get interactive. A lot of times, Allie's hanging out in the chat room.
Sometimes.
Tonight?
Yes.
All right, Allie's in there tonight. You can go to cam.freetalklive.com and check that out for free. Unlike a lot of those other talk show hosts, we don't charge you for the features on our website. Again, freetalklive.com. Free State Project, your best chance at achieving liberty in your lifetime is to get together with other people who think like you, people who understand what liberty means. I'm presuming you understand what liberty means. The idea being that you should be free to live your life how you want, so long as you don't harm anyone else, and that you understand that in order to be free, that you have to allow others to be free. So the idea is to bring people like that together and have them get active all in the same geographic area. Maybe someday we'll see New Hampshire secession, not seceding to join Canada or to seceding to join some other country, or but to actually secede from the United States. I'm excited about that idea. The Free State Project isn't an explicitly secessionist movement. It's a movement that has a simple statement of intent, and that is that you'll move to New Hampshire when 19,999 others agree to do so, and you'll get active to achieve a government that does, at most, protects the property,
life,
liberty.
Property.
So you can go to freestateproject.org to check that out, learn more about it. That's the reason the three of us are here together in the studio tonight. We're early movers. We've made the move to New Hampshire already, even though the Free State Project has yet to reach its 20,000 participant goal. It's over 15,500, though, at this point. So we're getting there, and there have been over 1,500 people. There are over 1,500 people that are already here in New Hampshire. Many of them are very active. Others are having success in politics and civil disobedience, and it's just been a wonderful experience so far.
Speaking of active people, just on the way over to the studio today, I saw a police officer with his lights on, and he had pulled someone over. And in those situations, if I'm on my way somewhere, I'm always thinking, oh, I wish I could somehow help the situation, but I have somewhere to be, which was here. Mm-hmm. And I saw Garrett out there filming the interaction. So I was like, oh, it's taken care of.
Nice. There's enough people around.
That's right.
Do you see that where you are? You're asking the listener.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, probably not. Our toll-free number. So check it out. Freestateproject.org. It's a really unique movement, and it's working. So we'll continue here. Go to your phone calls and thoughts. We've got Trey on the line on Skype. Hey, Trey.
Hey, y'all. How you doing?
What's on your mind tonight?
Well, I just wanted to point out, I guess, the hypocrisy of the U.S. government. And this happened over the Crimea issue. And what I'm going to talk about happened over 100 years ago in the late 1800s. But are y'all familiar with how Hawaii basically became a territory and subsequently a state of the U.S., right?
Yeah, I don't think I could give a symposium on it right now, but I'm right there with you.
I know it was under threat of force.
It was under threat of force. It was an illegal annexation. So what was happening was you had these American and European businessmen, mostly American businessmen in Hawaii, sugar farmers. They were landowners, right? And at some point, the existing Hawaiian constitution was changed to basically favor these landowners, and they changed the constitution to basically before the United States was the United States. You know, only landowners and property owners were able to have any major say of what went on as far as our relationship with England and all that kind of stuff. Mm-hmm. And it was the same thing there. So the Constitution changed. Loads of native poor Hawaiians lost their ability to, use their voice and vote. And power was given to a very small group of non-native Hawaiians.
So you're saying that people who were given the privilege to vote had that revoked, that they weren't allowed to vote anymore?
Exactly. Once Hawaiian was given their freedom from, I think it was a British.
Great Britain. It was the Sandwich Islands.
Exactly. A British territory. So then at some point, the United States kind of crippled the Hawaiian sugar industry, because what happened was they lowered import tariffs from other countries into the U.S. When they were importing sugar. So, because Hawaii was not a territory of the U.S., there was this coup that was set in place. And their thought was that, if we become a territory or if we become a part of the United States in some fashion, that way we won't have to pay these import tariffs because we'll be an American territory.
They used economic warfare to pressure them, is what you're saying.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Right. So that set in motion this thing over basically a decade or so to up to the point of the illegal annexation of Hawaii.
Now, and wasn't the Hawaii a kingdom? I mean, how is it that they were able to mess with the Constitution so easily from the outside?
So the king of the time, basically he changed the Constitution looking down the barrel of a gun. There was force threatened against him, and he changed the Constitution. Those rights were taken away from the native people. And then he died and his sister took over and she went to change the Constitution back. But there was a lot of bugaboo, a lot of screaming coming from these people who were a small minority and that threat and with the threat of force. And she kind of backed down. The USS Boston was sent to Hawaii, was anchored in port, or anchored off the coast there. And
that's not threatening or anything.
Yeah.
We're just
sending a big old gunship out there. What's the big deal?
Well, and what happened was they sent armed sailors to the island.
We call those Marines.
These at the time, these were Marines. They were
really?
They were sailors. Yeah, they were sailors.
All right.
They arrested the queen, imprisoned her.
Wow.
And,
yes.
And from there, it's just, it was just bad. So, I mean, maybe the disposition of Hawaii, maybe it was great that we got Hawaii when we did, because, I mean, you look at during World War II, if Japan would have gotten a hold of them, it would not have been so great. But the point is, the way the United States government is acting towards Crimea is completely hypocritical, because at least the Crimeans had a chance to vote on whether or not they wanted to become a part of the Russian Federation. Hawaii didn't have any chance to do that. They did, Native Hawaiians did sign a petition and they got over 21,000, which was half the population, because at the time, the population of Hawaii was only about 39,000 people, Native population. And so over half of the Native population of Hawaii signed a petition against annexation. So, I mean, we totally screwed the Hawaiians.
I didn't do anything. I'd just like to say I wasn't involved.
Don't you find that stories like this that are 100 years, more than 100 years old, just sort of fall on deaf ears? The people are like,
I find it fascinating.
Oh, I agree. I'm not saying that it's not fascinating. Yeah. I just don't, you know, nobody feels responsible. Oh, yeah, the United States did some terrible things to the Native Americans. Yes, yes, that's absolutely true. And sure, there was the Tuskegee Airmen, like the Tuskegee experiments, and the Guatemala thing that Hillary apologized for. But you know, it's been decades. We've got all that stuff handled.
Trey, thanks for your call. Good information. Good story tonight. Appreciate hearing from you. I felt like I learned something. 855 450 free. You take control here on Free Talk Live.
Virtually anyone can hack your cell phone and track your calls, your texts, your emails, your every movement, but only if they can detect a signal. Stay one step ahead of hackers and Big Brother with a Blockit Pocket, a custom-made pocket infused with pure silver that creates a complete Faraday enclosure for your cell phone. For free shipping to the Lower 48, visit blockitpocket.com or call 888-315-9618. blockitpocket.com. Enhancing health and privacy.
Did you know that organic sulfur can cleanse and defend your body against the poisons we're exposed to each day? Organic sulfur crystals from sulfurdefense.com help by forcing oxygen and nutrition into your cells while eliminating heavy metals, contaminants, and damaging radiation. Defend yourself and family from toxic assault with one of the most critical and essential minerals available today. Order online at sulfurdefense.com. That's sulfurdefense.com or call 800-593-6273.
Hi, I'm Derek J. I don't want a politician to represent me. To me, government is the idea that one group of people can coerce everyone to comply with an edict or face increasing punishments up to and including death. Despite perhaps the most noble of intentions, the best government services are a far cry from what could be provided for by voluntary interactions. Besides, the people who call themselves the government wage wars and put peaceful people in jail for crimes involving no victims. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
Stop harming your body with coffee from grocery stores or most chains. Start making a difference, one cup at a time. We've partnered with Camano Island Coffee Roasters to offer you a free pound of BuzzBox coffee. It's organic, so no harmful pesticides or toxins. Shade grown, meaning less acidity and no heartburn. Try the best of the best for free. Just cover shipping. 10% of future purchases go toward helping us give the gift of human freedom around the globe with at least 100 microloans via World Vision. Go to coffee.freetalklive.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Anyone can publish on the internet, but not everyone is publishing material suited for online reading. According to the Yahoo Style Guide, it cautions that internet content has a few seconds, three or less, to encourage people to read more, to take action, or navigate to another one of your pages. So make it easy for readers to pick and choose. Isn't that the way you poke around online? Use short words, short sentences, short paragraphs, bulleted lists, and short pages. Front load what you write, putting the most important information at the beginning of headlines and paragraphs and sentences. Same goes for your keywords. What someone would likely type into the search box on Yahoo or Google. For more tips on communicating better online or in a job interview or everyday life, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
¶¶
This is Free Talk Live. You are invited to take control of the airwaves via toll-free number or Skype. You can Skype in at username lrn.fm. Our toll-free number is brought to you by ProXPN, and you can connect to that by dialing 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Don't forget to check out freetalklive.com. We have a mobile site for those of you with a smartphone. And right now, it looks like the majority of Americans now have smartphones, over 61%. I think the last numbers I saw this month.
Who wants a dim-witted phone?
So some people do, because it can be annoying to actually make calls on a smartphone.
Sure can.
If you want to actually make a phone call, well, dim-witted phones can do a good job of it, I think.
I just remember having much better reception at one point in the past. Maybe I'm completely wrong here, but...
The issue's not reception. It's just a hassle, like, with the
transmitter.
Smartphone.
Well, plus, when you're driving down the road and you want to call somebody, you can't really... It doesn't have that feel, that tactile feel of a button.
Well, yeah, you used to be able to flip a phone open and press number 2 and call
Hold
Mark,
it down and then
you know?
Call... Yeah.
Can't do that anymore.
Women all over the country that had that number program.
If you've got a smartphone, you can connect to Free Talk Live's live streams via M, as in mobile.freetalklive.com. That's m.freetalklive.com.
Most people want to get ahead in life, and nearly all of Free Talk Live's listeners would like to be able to persuade people towards ideas. Maybe the ideas of freedom. I'm just guessing here. But did you know that some of the solutions that claim to help you grow actually backfire? The good news is that 70 years of science shows that even the best leaders can get better, but only if they practice in ways that actually work. Dr. Matt Barney, founder of LeaderAmp, has coached and taught thousands of successful leaders around the world for the last 20 years using the latest science of what works. Dr. Barney has drafted blueprints for a new smartphone application to measure each person and tailor a customized developmental plan, some of which will be pushed onto their smartphones. His vision is to build a community who can access approaches that really work and support each other's development as leaders. Uniquely, it will also allow you to compare your leadership with famous historical figures like Gandhi or Steve Jobs and help to see that they weren't perfect, but they overcame their own limitations with practice. The app isn't ready yet. It's being built, but if you want to help advance an approach to grow freedom lovers' persuasion skills, we'd love to have you join the community. Feel free to pre-order at the Indiegogo campaign. Just go to leaderamp.freetalklive.com and amp your leadership. It's leaderamp.freetalklive.com.
And that takes you to the Indiegogo campaign.
Correct.
For this, which I find this fascinating, and anything that can be done to help, I guess, promote the idea of being a good leader and just being a leader, period, within the liberty movement, I think is very, very valuable.
Well, within the liberty movement specifically, persuasion skills aren't in abundance, right? So What you'll find is a lot of people that want to debate points and beat the other person into the ground with their logic, with the flaming hammer of logic. Yeah, it's not particularly effective, and really we do need better skill sets when it comes to persuasion, and I think LeaderAmp can help with that.
Well, I just think having more leaders is a good thing, too. I mean, the more people that are doers, the more people that are instigators, the more people that are likely to start up something, because one of the things that this movement needs is people to instigate, people to start with an idea and put it out there and say, this is what I want to do, this is what I want to see happen, this is the activism that I think is most exciting, and put that idea out there for people to add to with their ideas and to join on with and get behind. And that's what I see as being something that we need more of. There are a lot of people who are willing to do. It's just they need to be asked to do. And I'd like to see more people just start stuff. So anyway, leaderamp.freetalklive.com sounds like it could help with that. We continue here. You are welcome to share your thoughts as we go to Stephen. He is in Utah on Skype. Stephen, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Ali, and Mark.
At top of the St. Patrick's Day to you.
Well, then, go ahead now.
You're a racist.
What?
I wanted to try to find a principle in the concept of voting for secession. Kind of seems like you have to use a bunch of different statist tools like voting to try to do something that's really anti-statist like secession. When would a percentage vote be legitimate for something like secession for New Hampshire seceding from the U.S.?
So are you saying that 51% of people shouldn't be able to decide for 49% of people whether a given geopolitical landmass...
Well, he was asking you.
He's asking?
Because you had made the statement earlier, right, Mark, that you thought 51% couldn't make a decision like that for the other 49%. So I think, and correct me if I'm wrong, Stephen, that you were asking, well, would there be a number at which that it would be okay?
Right. I mean, it's not right for 51% of people to steal from the 49% of their neighbors, but is it right for 51% to secede from the people that control them if the other 49% want those people to control them?
Ideally,
I see it as ultimately, I'd like each individual to be able to secede, right? Just like you can divorce an abusive spouse.
But, right. I think the answer is legitimately one vote.
Right.
The answer is if one person votes to leave a given geopolitical designation.
As I have done with the Shire Society Declaration.
That person legitimately can function within their own private property as a sovereign individual that has their own governance. Now, the question is when you step onto things like roads, there's no border checkpoint at my property. Where somebody gives me a good massage and sends me on my way.
I think you should have diplomatic immunity, personally.
And
I second that.
I don't think that it's.
I'll vote on that.
I don't think it's cool that if I secede, that I choose not to pay for these roads. Oh, I'm no longer part of your government, so I don't have to pay for these roads.
You still have to pay for the roads.
Use.
You get tolled all the time on these roads.
There's also gas taxes.
They tax you and they toll you.
Not in Cheshire County.
Okay.
Where I live, but I understand lots of roads. Do the tolls, and I think you're. At that point,
there are gas taxes, though, right? I mean, so
there
you'd
are
be
gas
paying
taxes.
For those.
Sure. Well, yeah. I mean, it's an interesting question. What if I bring in agricultural fuel, which don't have gas taxes on them, to my property? Use the agricultural fuel to run my vehicle, and then I choose, not to pay. So I think that there's this kind of there needs to be some level of reciprocity that when it comes into all these little sovereign nations of one getting along.
Well, I have no problem paying for things I use.
Same here.
That's why the Shire Free Church gave a 45% contribution to the city of Keene when they were demanding property taxes from us in this last property tax bill.
I mean, if you went to Canada, would you feel like obligated to pay for the roads that you drove on while you were there? If you're visiting another nation, would you feel obligated to pay into their taxes?
Every time that you buy something at a store, you're paying into their taxes, right? So every time, and unless you go to Canada and spend absolute zero, as far as you don't buy gas, you don't buy food, you don't buy anything, then you're going to be contributing to their system.
But taxes don't work where it's like pay per use. It's just like pay us or we will put you in jail.
Gas taxes kind of do work that way. I mean, they're about as close as you can get, except for sort of electric vehicles and that kind of thing. They're about as close as you can get to pay per use. So
okay.
Okay,
so the second part to my question, then I'll hop off, is at what percentage of people would there need to be in New Hampshire to vote for secession to where it would reach the critical mass of where the legislator would work to secede from the United States?
Well, first of all, in New Hampshire, there's not any kind of petitioning process to get something on a ballot, so you would never have a vote for secession that I know of. At least maybe there's some way. Well, maybe, actually, I think maybe if the state legislature puts in a constitutional question,
I think I'm going to come a little bit closer to this. The fact is that New Hampshire has a citizen legislature, so it couldn't be less than 50% because it's such a big issue, right? Like seceding from the United States, not something you're going to slip by in the dark of night. So
wouldn't that be great if we woke up tomorrow and it was in the newspaper?
So
that's how income taxes were established, I mean, 1912, 13, night before Christmas, isn't that how they got income taxes?
They
in?
Did, but this
did
is
that shyster thing the other
you're
way.
You're taking people's flags and eagles away, man.
They can keep the flags. That's the thing.
You could have flags with different colors and stars and stuff. Agreed. I think the answer is about 50% because of the citizen legislature and the way it would be set up, it could probably be done with about 50%.
Well, I think, and there's a constitutional amendment factor here that I think I want to point out in a moment. Thanks for the call, Stephen. We'll continue the discussion here next on Free Talk Live.
The following is an important free offer for smokers only. The makers of Victor, the world's most advanced e-cigarette, have just authorized the release of free starter kits to all smokers who call in the next 10 minutes. valued at $99, these Victor starter kits are available for free, but only while supplies last. To guarantee your free kit, call in the next 10 minutes, 1-800-564-6941. The revolutionary Victor design creates only water vapor. There is no foul-smelling smoke and no unhealthy tar. This allows individuals to enjoy the nicotine they love without restriction, no matter where they are. The financial advantages over cigarettes are considerable as well. It is estimated that the average smoker can save hundreds of dollars a month with Victor. Again, free Victor starter kits are now available to any smoker who calls in the next 10 minutes. This is a radio-only offer not available in stores, so call now for your free kit. 1-800-564-6941. 1-800-564-6941. 1-800-564-6941.
Hey everyone, have you heard about the no-no hair removal device that's sweeping the globe? If you want to go weeks without shaving and get smooth, professional, quality results, here's our favorite host, Cheryl, for no-no hair removal.
Thanks. Hey gals, I love talking about my no-no. It's this cute little hair removal system that you can take with you and use almost anywhere at home or on the road. No more expensive in-office treatments, painful waxing, and no more wasting your valuable time. Got unwanted facial hair? No-no has patented Thermacon technology that works on all hair and skin colors, so it's perfect for using on all body parts. And now you can take advantage of this incredible risk-free trial. Get the No-No, the facial kit, a travel case, and a $100 discount shopping card, and you don't risk a penny to try it. Try the incredible No-No hair completely risk-free. Call 1-800-953-6062. That's 800-953-6062. 800-953-6062.
Free Talk Live.
When there are cameras around, it doesn't make a difference. There were people with video cameras all over this event yesterday.
That's and good. It looked like these people were trying to get away.
Yes,
honestly.
They were. Yes, they were. They
I
were
mean,
being
these weren't
shot.
People rushing towards the cop phalanx.
Nope.
That's right.
They were trying to get away.
And those batons weren't rubber like the bullets were.
They were either trying to get away or they were members of the news media trying to cover the event.
Right.
Police are supposed to be there to protect and serve. Allegedly to be peace officers. And instead, they're creating war.
And, of course, the chief of police is claiming he'll investigate. What they're going to investigate, I don't know. It's going to be very difficult to identify the officers in this video footage because there were so many of them.
Mm-hmm.
There was an army of police officers out there, and every single one of them was participating in the attack on unarmed, innocent people.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
MeowBit is free software from the Freedom Fiends that allows you to effortlessly view .bit websites. MeowBit works on all browsers. .bit is a new type of web address that's not controlled by any government or corporation. And we'll show you how to register a .bit domain today using a few cents worth of Namecoin. If anyone ever shuts down your .com website, users will still be able to get to your site using your .bit address in our free software, MeowBit. Go to meowbit.com. That's MeowBit.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can bring up whatever you want right here, toll-free, 855-450-FREE. We've been talking about secession, the idea of not just state secession, but personal secession. If a state can declare independence from another state, which of course these are just ideas, states are just ideas that are human beings using violence and the threat of violence over other human beings to get their way and to get obedience and money out of those other human beings. But if one state can secede, then shouldn't an individual be able to secede as well?
Well, what would that mean? What would it entail, seceding?
Well, removing your allegiance. So during your school years, you were likely declaring your allegiance on a daily basis pledging.
Through expression. Pledging allegiance.
Yes, you were. You literally were pledging your allegiance to the United States,
right.
Even though you, for a long time, probably didn't really know what that meant. You were doing it. And so the idea of a personal secession would be to remove such a pledge of allegiance and to swear allegiance to yourself.
Is it more like a symbolic...
Or another society.
Symbolic sentiment?
Saying, what do you mean?
Like, I declare my independence and I take back everything I was saying about America before I decided that I don't want to be part of this collective known as the United States or New Hampshire or Keene.
Well, yeah, it's absolutely symbolic. But by asking that question, do you mean that it also is meaningless beyond the symbolism?
Does it have, do some actions, is there some process for what you're talking about, seceding as an individual?
Well, that's a good question. So we were actually talking about Roger Ver on the air the other day. There was an article, I don't think you were on the show on that day, Mark, but there's an article written about Roger Ver, aka Bitcoin Jesus, kind of talking about his story, a little bit about his past, and you know, he went to prison for apparently selling fireworks on eBay for, I think he went to 8 months in prison for
that. It's the equivalent of fireworks. They're actually rat traps.
Okay, well, they said fireworks in the article, so
it's easier to understand. Basically, there's an M80 in a box. The rat goes in the box, and bang, kills the rat.
Oh, wow, that sounds messy. Well, but anyway,
it's
fireworks with practicality involved.
This is how, I mean, this is sort of an agricultural level. I mean, we're not talking about baiting traps out in the wild.
So anyway. Roger, he's going through the process of renouncing citizenship. Because he's gotten citizenship, so-called, in another political designation, in another country.
Okay.
And now he wants to renounce his U.S. citizenship. So that's one answer to your question.
That sounds like a lengthy process.
Yes,
what
and it's expensive and hassle process. But there's another idea, which is the Shire Society. You can go to shiresociety.com and read the Shire Society Declaration, which is a personal declaration of independence. The Shire Society Declaration is... It's personally empowering. It has personal significance, but it's not. You're not sending a copy of it to the United States government. So it's the kind of the opposite of what Roger Ver is doing, in that he's asking the U.S. government to let him go, so to speak. And a signer of the Shire Society Declaration would be just simply declaring their own personal independence. Which, of course, you know, if they want to come after you, they're going to come after you, whether or not you get their permission slip.
They consider this piece of land theirs,
yeah.
And that's evidenced by the fact that they'll tax the land. They decide where the land goes. If they want to put a road through your land, they'll do that.
The thing is, I don't believe I am a citizen because I don't think there's any evidence to prove that anyone is in point of fact a citizen. If they're going to claim that I'm the citizen, then I would like them to prove that claim. Because as we've said multiple times and we'll continue to point out to people, because this doesn't get a whole lot of press coverage, but there have been multiple court cases where the Supreme Court has decided that the government has no obligation to provide you with any services, and it certainly has no obligation to protect you. So if you look up the definition of citizen is one who owes a duty of allegiance, like pledging allegiance and doing what you're told, owes a duty of allegiance in return for an obligation of protection. So because there's no obligation to protect, you couldn't possibly owe them a duty of allegiance. So therefore, there is no citizen. So so my viewpoint is that the whole citizen thing has been a lie from day number one. And all you have to do is just simply stop believing in it. That's, again, not going to stop them from believing in it.
They still believe in it.
Yes. But if enough people, this is all really we're talking about here, are the beliefs that people have. And that's why the state exists, because people believe in it. They see the state as something else besides human beings who are using force on others. And if we can change that, then political secession won't even really matter. If we can change enough hearts and minds on that. But, oh, that reminds me. I wanted to correct something that, or I guess expound upon something that I was trying to say as we went out to the
last
break.
Sounds like correct to me.
So you had kind of given an explanation about voting and secession and percentages, Mark, and what I wanted to say about New Hampshire as far as voting for secession, how that would happen here if it were to actually occur, would be that they would have to go through the constitutional amendment process in Concord, which would mean that they could either do a general court vote. General court is the name for the state legislature here. So 3/5 of the general court can vote for a proposed constitutional amendment.
This would be the state representatives voting?
That's correct.
400 of them.
So, right, of the 400 people, three-fifths of them would have to propose, you know, vote for something that says we're going to secede from the United States. Then it would go to ratification by the people at the next following November election, biennial election.
So, be open to the general public.
That's correct. So then it would be a two-thirds vote of the general public. So recently this happened in 2012 where the state representatives passed a proposed resolution amendment to ban the income tax forever in New Hampshire.
Wow.
So that passed the state house three-fifths for proposed amendment, but it did not pass the two-thirds required to actually go in as an amendment. So it failed as a constitutional amendment, but 58% did vote for it. So it was a majority of New Hampshire voters wanted to see the income tax banned forever because we don't have a personal income tax in New Hampshire, but not 66 or 67%. So it didn't make the cut. So there you go. There's also the constitutional convention method as well, which is a little bit more detailed. Majority vote of both houses in that case is required to place a question on the ballot. Shall there be a convention to amend or revise the Constitution? If such a question has not been submitted to the people in 10 years, the Secretary of State is required to place the question on the ballot. So apparently that question comes up every 10 years regardless of whether or not it's actually been suggested by the legislature. And then if they have a convention, a majority of qualified voters participating in election is required. In order to get the convention, a majority of voters would have to agree to it. And then at the next election, delegates are elected by the people or earlier as provided by the general court. And a three-fifths vote of the number of delegates is required to send the constitutional amendment to a vote. So there's no way a constitutional amendment can get through in New Hampshire without a two-thirds vote of the people on that amendment. Does that make sense?
Yep, got it.
So the constitutional convention process is much longer, but ultimately whatever they come up with, if they have the constitutional convention, still goes to the people for a vote.
Wow, okay.
So there you go. And again, that's just how it happens here in New Hampshire. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. I think this is such an important issue, the idea of secession, because if we can get people thinking and favoring the idea of secession in places like Crimea or other places around the world, and then start talking about it happening here in the United States, let's bring it up at dinner conversations. Bring it up in the workplace. Start talking about the idea of secession and take it seriously.
Well, it's interesting because the United States is already broken up into states, so people here are already used to thinking of themselves as identifying more with a local population than with an entire country in general.
You know, this secession thing came up here in the United States with sort of the Texas wanting to secede
after the election recently.
Yeah, putting in something to whitehouse.gov or whatever it was.
That's right.
It was interesting to hear the caterwauling. Now, what I never heard, you'd hear things like, oh, it's unconstitutional. And the Supreme Court certainly, the federal government has ruled that it is unconstitutional for anyone that the federal government doesn't want to leave the federal government to leave, right? Like that's what they've ruled, and which is a ridiculous ruling. If you can vote, which you know the first states did, and actually all the states petitioned to be in the country, if you can vote to be part of the United States, then you should be able to vote to not be part of the United States. Anything other than that is absolutely ludicrous, and I don't care what body made that decision. Some people would call it unconstitutional. Others were like things like, well, Alabama is a tax negative state. If they leave, then they'll be losing money. Now, they never say, like, they just kind of, you know, there's some level of indignation about it, and yes, that's a true statement. So what? If Alabama, a majority of people in Alabama choose to want to leave the United States, what do you care if they're tax negative?
What does tax negative mean?
Tax negative means that they receive more federal dollars than they pay in is the supposed thing. I don't understand how this works.
And by they, you mean the state government. And the people pay it in, but the state government receives the money. The people certainly don't.
In theory, I don't understand how any state is actually tax negative because there's so many government bureaucrats that get paid so much money, I can't imagine that any state gets more than it pays.
We will come back with more of your thoughts. You may make the call toll-free to 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Venezuelan protests coming up.
Quantum Vibe. It's year 2523. people travel in bubbles, fly at hyperspeed, with brain implants and artificial gravity. A scientific genius and his clever assistant set out on an adventure through the solar system on a secret mission to find the key to access new frontiers and save liberty. QuantumVibe.com from Big Head Press.
The flooring experts at Lumber Liquidators have over 8 million square feet of top-quality flooring that must be cleared out by March 31st. Get donor oak laminate flooring for only 49 cents a square foot. Exotic black mamba hand-scraped bamboo for just $1.89. Even 3/4-inch pre-finished hickory hardwood for an unheard-of $2.59 a square foot. They've got free samples at your local store, plus 22-month special financing available. So go to LumberLiquidators.com now to find the store nearest you.
My name is Jacob Hornberger. I'm president of the Future of Freedom Foundation, which Congressman Ron Paul awarded for having an outstanding freedom website. Write us at fff@fff.org, and we'll send you a free 3-month subscription to our monthly journal of libertarian essays and our booklet, Economic Liberty in the Constitution, which George Mason University economics professor Walter Williams praised in a recent column. That's fff@fff.org.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates. Online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Monday, March 17th, 2014. Gold opened today at $1,378, silver opened at $21.27, and Bitcoin is trading at $623.80. Support for Liberty Beat comes from GrowYourOwnGroceries.org. Learn to grow, prepare, and preserve your own food and medicine at GrowYourOwnGroceries.org. Support also comes from Affordable Sound, CD and DVD duplication, along with posters and promotions materials. Online at AffordableSound.com. Or call them 512-459-5253. In the news, the United States government is ready to surrender control of the Internet. On Friday, the Assistant Secretary of Commerce for Communications and Information told the Washington Post the federal government plans to end or drastically reduce the contract between the Commerce Department and the Internet Corporation for assigned names and numbers. Russia Today reports the move comes as federal agencies face intense pressure from the international community to step back from Internet oversight. The pressure built after Edward Snowden leaked NSA documents proving use of the Internet for spying by the feds. An exact timeline for the change is not yet formulated. The former chief counsel for the Church Committee is calling for a new committee investigation into secret government activities. Frederick A.O. Fritz Schwartz Jr. and the Church Committee helped expose abuses by the federal government in the 1970s, including the counterintelligence programs known as COINTELPRO that targeted activists and everyday Americans seen as threats. Now, in light of revelations by Snowden, Schwartz is once again calling for a committee to investigate abuses by the government. The man outed by Newsweek as the creator of Bitcoin hires a lawyer and issues a statement denying his involvement with the cryptocurrency. Dorian Satoshi Nakamoto's statement, released early Monday by his lawyer, calls the magazine story a false report and says it's harmed his prospects for gainful employment. The statement further states the article has been the source of a great deal of confusion and stress. Nakamoto, in the statement, says this will be his final public comment on the matter and asks that his privacy be respected. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from Sovereign BTC, media, marketing, and consulting for the Bitcoin ecosystem. Operated by Liberty Beat founder John Bush. Online at sovereignbtc.com. Support also comes from The Corey Moore Show, live Friday nights, 9 o'clock Central Time, at CoreyMooreShow.com. And support comes from Robertson Roberts Brokerage, Inc., precious metals at reasonable rates since 1977. Online at rrbi.co. This is the Liberty Beat for Monday, March 17, 2014. check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. As Brazil prepares to host the 2014 World Cup, the use of death squads increases. The World Cup runs from June 12th to July 13th in Rio de Janeiro. And in preparation, many of the poorest citizens are being forced out of their homes and sometimes murdered. These shanty towns in Rio de Janeiro are home to nearly 1.5 million of the poorest Brazilians. With the city being named the host of both the 2014 World Cup and the 2016 Summer Olympics, the Brazilian government has been doing its best to remove anything that may be seen as less than favorable. Breaking free from Big Pharma and doing it yourself. That's the goal behind an 8-week online course known as Home Medicine 101. The class, presented by Nicole Telkies of Austin, Texas, will focus on ways to treat the most common family ailments with simple medicines that can be grown or easily acquired. At the conclusion of the 8 weeks, students will be armed with ways to manage a variety of common conditions, ranging from digestive problems to coughs and fevers. Information about the program can be found online at growyourowngroceries.org. Researchers at McGill University in Quebec believe they've found a link between mindfulness meditation and reducing cravings for chocolate. In a study published in the journal Appetite, the researchers discussed how the practice of non-attachment to thoughts during mindfulness meditation may weaken chocolate cravings among sweet lovers. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from Central Texas Gunworks, CHL courses, self-defense training, and firearm sales. Give them a call at 512-731-3585 or online at centraltexasgunworks.com. And support for the Liberty Beat comes from Cabo Bob's, Southwest Burritos, and Homemade Tortillas. Online at CaboBob's.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Monday, March 17th, 2014. I'm Brian Hagan reporting. Reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
Following morning reports indicating that Philadelphia High School for the Performing Arts student Samantha Bylum deals with really weird social pressures on a daily basis, Onion reporters met with the 16-year-old dance student who described feeling regularly alienated from her peers for extremely bizarre reasons.
If you're not up to date on the latest urban street art or Esperanza Spalding albums, the other students will eat you alive. It can get pretty brutal. Just the other day, everyone cut class to go watch the Million Dollar Quartet musical at the Forest Theater, but nobody told me. Now I'm the only one that hasn't seen Lance Guest's rendition of Folsom Prison Blues. It's humiliating.
According to Bylum, the school year shows no sign of letting up as she continues dealing with the everyday stresses of auditioning for the school's production of My Fair Lady, keeping up with the latest punk Afrofusion dance groups, and not having enough fishnet sleeves to wear throughout the week.
Honestly, I don't know how the other students deal with it.
Keep checking theonion.com for more as this story develops.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. We're launching into the second hour of the program. Dial in toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And Skype us. Username there is lrn.fm, so feel free to reach out in that way if you prefer. With you in studio tonight, Ian here.
Allie.
And Mark.
Allie's here from her radio show, ALP, and that stands for something different every week.
That's right. Yep. Well,
what was it last week?
Last week we talked about the... appeals to authority and the logical fallacy. We sort of got into that a little bit, had some callers. So it was a really interesting discussion because when it comes to logical fallacies, you may know what the different ones are, but not quite when you're violating one of them. So that was a very, it was a big learning experience for all of us because some of the callers called in and knew more about you know, what the fallacies actually entail than I even knew. So it was interesting.
And the fact is that we as human beings use logical fallacies. I don't know anyone that can actually operate in the course of, say, a month and not use one of these things in the course of your thinking. Now, that doesn't make it okay. It's just you know, like the sunken cost fallacy always gets me, which is I paid money into this situation. Like, right now, I've got a 2003 Honda Element. Mm-hmm. I just paid $1,500 to get the thing fixed. It's probably not worth much more than that. It's got dents all in it, and, you know.
You don't think?
I think it's probably worth $4,000.
Okay.
So I just spent $1,500 after $4,000. Should I have just gone ahead and traded it in and got something else that wasn't going to give me the problems?
Possibly.
I mean, it's really difficult to know what to do.
Of course, if you get another car, you might get more problems, right? If you get a used car, you never know what you're inheriting.
It's true. Usually,
the devil you know.
Yeah, I don't. I tend to think that most cars that are sold these days are pretty good, American or otherwise.
You mean used cars?
Well, I mean,
would you be buying new or
used? You don't buy a 20-year-old used car, Ian. You buy something that's 2 or 3 years old. It hasn't had a chance for things to go wrong too badly.
Yeah, you never know.
You never know. You don't know. So a lot of times, if you get a car that's coming off of lease or something like that, the oil changes have been covered in the maintenance plan for that vehicle, right. So the person's likely to have done the oil changes, and you're not looking at that problem. Usually you can tell if a vehicle that has 40 or 50,000 miles on it hasn't had regular oil changes, at least regular enough oil changes, because it's going to run like crap.
Well, yeah, there's all kinds of. I think that's fascinating, Allie, that you guys got into that, and that's something you do on ALP is you really dig into a topic. And we've been digging into the topic tonight of secession to
that's
some
right.
extent here on Free Talk Live. But go to ALPShow.com to get more of Allie and Ellen, her co-host, and other guests.
Yes.
ALPShow.com. Also, it's ALP Podcast on Facebook. So you had some secession-related news as well.
That's right. We've been talking a lot about tonight, but I actually found the story before I knew we were going to be talking so much about secession. It's about Venice wanting to secede from Italy, and I didn't realize anything about the history of Venice originally sort of being part of a more sovereign entity, but I'll just read from the story from thenationalpost.com. Voting began Sunday on a referendum Uh-oh. On whether Venice and its surrounding region... What?
Wait, National Post?
Why? Is that bad?
Go ahead and read the story. I want to hear what it
is. It's a little short one. But,
okay, maybe I'm thinking of something different. I thought National Post was a... there is one of those onion-like sites that's got a name like National Post, and I'm forgetting what it's called.
Well, my original source for the story was on a different computer, so I just typed in the... it's the same story, just from a different site.
So you have a second site, okay.
Corroboration's good.
So voting began Sunday on a referendum on whether Venice and its surrounding region should secede from the rest of Italy in an attempt to restore its 1,000-year history as a sovereign republic. La Serenissima, or the Most Serene Republic of Venice, was an independent trading power for a millennium before its last leader was deposed by Napoleon in 1797. The Republic encompassed not just Venice, but what is the now surrounding region of Veneto, and it is there that the vote will take place from Sunday until Friday. Campaigners have been inspired by the example of Scotland, which will hold its referendum on Independence Day in September, and Catalonia, where around half of the population say they want to break away from Spain. Activists say the latest polling shows that 65% of voters in the Veneto region, which includes historic sites such as Treviso, Vicenza, and Verona, are in favor of cutting ties with Rome.
Very
exciting. So 65%. That sounds like a majority. And as far as I know, the campaigners for this want to want to go ahead and draw up a sort of declaration of independence or something like that if it gets a majority.
Yeah, I'm for smaller geopolitical designations. I think that there's a lot of advantages. Yeah, they can ally with each other in whatever way they do, but I think that people are better served with smaller governments. When you have a big power like the United States or Russia, that power then concentrates into a city. No one would argue that Washington, D.C. is the most powerful city on the planet. People that are educated in the subject would see the incredible amount of power that D.C. has around the world. I mean, setting policy in other nations, forcing policy on other nations. And this is a bad thing. And it's because of how few nations there are. If nations, if states could secede from the United States, it would take money and power away from Washington, D.C., therefore bringing power down to closer to the individual. Yeah, I'm not a big fan of local government either. I just tend to think that you're going to have more voice in a local government than you would in a national one.
Well, for the same things you were talking about with the United States government and D.C. having so much power over the rest of the world, is the same kind of reasons why if it was left up to a vote, some kind of option between, you know, being able to stay in the United States but be, you know, some entity with another government like Canada, or who knows, if it could be open to any country in the world, I think that I could vote for most other countries besides the United States, because I think that not just because the United States seems to be the most tyrannical government and I'd rather pay taxes to a nicer, you know, slave driver if I had the option to, like, switch them. Does that make sense? Does my analogy?
It doesn't. I guess. I mean, I'm not real. I'm going to have some questions for you when you're done.
Well, it's also because I think that in general, colonies seem to be harder to control for nations. If you have to go out of your way to enforce laws, well, than it seems to
New
be.
New Hampshire wouldn't. I mean, wouldn't be out of the way of Canada.
That's true.
Directly connected.
But if it say it was, you know, a country further away or something. Mm-hmm. Then it could be, you could see more freedom if you weren't controlled by, you know, the scariest government on earth.
You might have an argument there, but Mark, you said you had questions.
Well, I just, you know, I mean, for one, I don't think that the United States is better than many other governments, you know, or worse than many other governments. I think that, you know, they have their pluses and minuses.
You wouldn't say that it's worse than other, you wouldn't compare countries and say their policies do more damage than in other countries?
Many countries are poorer than the United States. If they had more money, they'd fly remote control airplanes around and kill people too. So the you know, the poverty of a nation doesn't, poverty isn't virtue. And the U.S. government doesn't want other nations to have any kind of real, national power. So, you know, as far as military goes, so the fact that nations choose not just basically sublimate themselves to the United States government's military, saying, oh, OK, if you guys are going to keep the shipping lanes clear, we just won't put that many ships out there. That's fine. Just enough to make us look like a real country and everything. And so, you know, the United States is a good place to make money. If you want to go someplace after you've made enough money to live the rest of your life and some kind of relative wealth, I think that that's fine.
Well, a lot of people leave the United States and expatriate to other countries.
They do. Just listened to a podcast today about moving to Acapulco.
All right, we'll come back with more here. You're welcome to add into the discussion, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Take control of the airwaves here on Free Talk Live. We also have Skype. You can Skype in. Add username lrn.fm. Secession's on the table for discussion, but you can bring up anything you want here on Free Talk Live.
The following is an important free offer for smokers only. The makers of Victor, the world's most advanced e-cigarette, have just authorized the release of free starter kits to all smokers who call in the next 10 minutes. Valued at $99, these Victor starter kits are available for free, but only while supplies last. To guarantee your free kit, call in the next 10 minutes, 1-800-564-6941. The revolutionary Victor design creates only water vapor. There is no foul-smelling smoke and no unhealthy tar. This allows individuals to enjoy the nicotine they love without restriction, no matter where they are. The financial advantages over cigarettes are considerable as well. It is estimated that the average smoker can save hundreds of dollars a month with Victor. Again, free Victor starter kits are now available to any smoker who calls in the next 10 minutes. This is a radio-only offer not available in stores, so call now for your free kit. 1-800-564-6941. 1-800-564-6941. 1-800-564-6941.
Gold isn't for you? Ted Anderson, president of Midas Resources, one of the world's premier gold and precious metal investing firms. I get it. You wouldn't buy gold if you believed that the government is doing a great job, that the Fed will stop handing out trillions of dollars like bailout candy, that Social Security would be there for you. That's not what's happening. You might even pass on gold if the stimulus package wouldn't fuel inflation, or that the dollar wouldn't lose value, or that your retirement would be secure. If all looks rosy to you, then now is not the time to buy gold. For the realists, there have never been more sobering reasons to diversify with gold. Since 2001, the U.S. dollar index has tanked 30% while gold has risen 300%. Right now, savvy investors are adding gold to their portfolios. You should too. Find out what they know. Call us and I'll send you 10 reasons why gold will do very well, free. 800-686-2237. 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
The warning signs.
At first, he made me feel special. He promised he'd look after me, provide for my future. He broke every promise he made.
Millions of Americans afflicted.
I was ready to leave, but he told me he'd change. So I gave him another chance. I was such a fool.
The consequences.
Things only got worse. He started making my decisions for me, about my job, my kids' education, my money, my safety, my future. He took away my choices, but I kept going back to the same politicians.
The diagnosis? Battered voter syndrome.
I fell for the same old lies. They were just playing with my emotions, telling me what I wanted to hear. That's not right.
Stop the insanity of voting for the same old abusers. Declare your independence from the two-party system and join the New Hampshire Liberty Party today at nhliberty.info.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com. This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
All right, this is Free Talk Live. Now, you can bring up anything you want here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. Still to come, the Venezuelan conflict. The Ukraine is not the only place in the world where people are conflicting over the issues and political change. Venezuela's got some hot streets at the moment. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Plus, an 81-year-old great-grandmother has been put in jail. We'll tell you what for. Blockchain.info is where you can go right now to get your own Bitcoin wallet. Although I heard that earlier they were having technical difficulties. In fact, they are still having those technical difficulties. They are updating a Twitter feed. If you go to blockchain.info, they link to their Twitter feed there to let you know they're having hardware issues, not security issues. There's been some sort of hardware failure, and they are diligently working to get the site back online. But when it comes back up, you'll be able to get access to a Bitcoin wallet that you can get for free. So if you haven't yet gotten a Bitcoin wallet, Blockchain's got the best one out there that's easy to use. You can put an app on your Android phone, or if you've got an iPhone or something else, you can just go to their website and use their HTML5 wallet built right into the site. Blockchain.info makes it easy, and it's free to go get your Bitcoin wallet today and get started with Bitcoin at blockchain.info. Our toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. Venezuela. Police in Venezuela, according to rawstory.com, have stepped up a campaign of arrests and raids, as authorities said the death toll from more than a month of anti-government demonstrations had risen to 28. Now, in Venezuela, we've been kind of following
28, that's frankly, a lot of people. It's not very many comparatively. I mean, there's been a lot of anti-government protests around the world in the last half decade, and 28 is low. It's a tragedy for every person.
Horrible.
Yeah, it's horrible. Yeah. I'm not claiming it's not, but it's just not the numbers, right?
Well, I don't know what to compare it to, Mark.
Turkey, last year.
How many died there?
Many more than 28.
Well, anyway, it's still important news, and the death toll doesn't really matter to me. We don't know how many people are being injured. That number's not being reported here, and how many people are having their lives destroyed by all of this upset. So we've been kind of following Venezuela here and there as they've been making news. It seems like there's three countries that we report on the most, Venezuela, Russia, and North Korea.
Yeah.
Am I leaving any out? Those seem like the three that we're really kind of like to do news from here on Free Talk Live. There's just interesting things going on there. At least the interesting things that are going on there managed to reach us here. And so what happened, just to kind of give you a recap of some of the more recent news from Venezuela, as you know, may recall, Hugo Chavez was the main dictator. I think they call him the president there. And he died due to cancer. There, of course, was plenty of crazy socialist things that he did with his presidency. And now his second in command, Nicolas Maduro, is in charge of the country, and I think he's like a former bus driver or something like that. So, you know, he's a man of the people.
Directing the country.
And
he would direct a bus.
He has also been doing the same nationalization process that his predecessor had done with notable takeovers of grocery chains and also an electronics store at one point, or a chain of electronics stores, kind of like the Best Buy of Venezuela. He took them over.
Put down the tyranny of modern conveniences.
And basically he was forcing companies to sell at certain prices. He would not allow them to set their own prices. He came in and forced that. So there's been all kinds of things developing there, and apparently it's now developed into serious in the streets kind of action. President Nicolas Maduro has vowed to take drastic measures to quell the student-led protest movement launched on February 4th, fueled by public fury over deteriorating living conditions in the oil-rich country. They have a difficult time in Venezuela getting toilet paper.
Mm.
Hmm.
So try to imagine, you know, this is something we take for granted here in the United States and a lot of other places around the world. You take for granted then when you go to the bathroom, there's going to be a roll of toilet paper
available.
Depends
on who you live with.
I suppose so, but we probably shouldn't go indicting anybody.
Oh, the ladies.
But generally, in the United States, it's not a problem to find toilet paper around. But in Venezuela, there have been shortages, and that has directly to do with government involvement.
Well, what is it? They have to charge. They can't charge a certain amount for toilet paper. They have to keep it under a certain price, so
I am not certain. It wouldn't surprise me if that were the case, Allie. I'm not certain as to the exact political machinations that have made it difficult. If you've been following the Venezuelan situation closely and can answer that question well, you should call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. But they have had shortages on toilet paper. They've had inflation that's been pretty crazy. And that's combined to create the most serious challenge yet for the leftist Maduro, who succeeded the late Hugo Chavez last year. Police on Thursday arrested six people in a pre-dawn raid in the city of Valencia, where two civilians and a police officer were shot dead on Wednesday. In the evening, about 30 people were detained in the capital of Caracas. And late Thursday, about 100 demonstrators wearing hoods clashed with riot police in the same area and set fire to one of their motorcycles. No injuries were reported there. Authorities seized weapons, plastic explosives, and incendiary devices in Valencia.
Where do they get plastic explosives?
I think you make them somehow. I don't know how you go about doing that, but there are probably instructions on the internet, Mark. If you start Googling around, you might find them.
No thanks.
Maduro
Use ProXPN.
Said that searches were ongoing. Earlier in the day, Venezuelan state prosecutor Luisa Ortega Diaz, speaking on the sidelines of UN's Human Rights Council in Geneva, said 28 people had been killed and 365 injured since the protests first erupted. What began in Venezuela as a peaceful demonstration has been transformed into violence and chaos, she said. And then they go on to talk to John Kerry as to what his opinion is has any sort of relevance here. Going on, initially angered by rampant crime that a local watchdog says was responsible for 65 murders a day last year, protesters are also now seething about runaway inflation and the arrests of the demonstrators. Everyday sporadic protests are seen, sometimes ending in clashes with security forces. Roads have been barricaded in parts of some cities. So, I mean, this is pretty serious,
yeah, they're serious
conflict happening in Venezuela. And Maduro says that the protests are part of a U.S. plot to overthrow him.
how do you know that they're not?
Repeated calls for the opposition to join talks Repeated calls for the opposition to join talks organized by the authorities. That's a non-complete sentence. Student leader Juan Requenses says he'd never received a formal invitation to the talks. If the government does not want to pay attention to the people, all that we have left is to block the streets, he said.
You know, I absolutely believe this, is that the government would say, sure, we're in talks with them. We yell things through loudspeakers at their asses. But, you know, the guy says he didn't get a... What else would these protesters want except to get into talks with the government?
I'm sorry. I misread the sentence earlier. It's Maduro is repeating calls, meaning the president, el presidente, is saying that, I want to talk with the opposition, and we're ready to talk. But now, you know, the students are saying that's... they're not inviting them at all. South American foreign ministers have agreed to form a commission to support talks between the opposition and the Venezuelan government. And I'm sure that if the talks did happen, unless they managed to bribe these protesters into silence, I don't know if they're going to go anywhere. These guys seem pretty upset. They're serious.
They're blocking streets.
And they're in the streets, and people are getting killed as a result of this. If you want to share your perspective, maybe you're down there in Venezuela or nearby and you're more connected with the story, feel free to add your details to the mix here at 855-450-FREE. Otherwise, we're going to bring it back to the U.S. coming up here with your grandmother, or at least a lady who could be your grandmother, going to jail. We'll tell you what for here in moments. And you can share your thoughts as well at 855-450-FREE here on Free Talk Live.
It's already too late. Criminals have kicked in your door and are now in your home. Before this happens, homeowners have a choice. One, do nothing and hope you aren't one of the 1.4 million families attacked each year. Or two, refuse to be a victim. And for as low as $59, reinforce your doors with Door Devils. Door Devils simply attach to existing door frames and have proven to stop the biggest bad guys from kicking in doors. Read our police testimonials of real-life events at DoorDevil.com. Alarms don't stop kick-ins, we do. DoorDevil.com. That's the sound of your door being kicked in by an intruder with a single kick. Criminals know that your doors are weak and your alarm system can't keep them out. That's the sound of the same door, now protected by the Door Sentinel. Standard locks, deadbolts, and alarm systems can't prevent forced entry. Harden your door and door jamb with the Door Sentinel. Go to MySafeDoor.com. That's MySafeDoor.com and enter coupon code SAFE for 15% off of your order. The Door Sentinel, your home's first line of defense.
If you are like most people, chances are you're malnourished. Most people do not get the 90 essential nutrients the body needs to survive. This lack of nutrition can lead to all sorts of health issues. If you don't feel as good as you'd like, or if you're looking to get a jump start on a new, healthier you, Youngevity has your answer. With the Healthy Start Pack, you get all the nutrients your body needs. With all 90 essential nutrients and 115 fruits and vegetables, you get a supplement system that is antioxidant-rich and beyond compare. The Healthy Start Pack includes products backed by 40 years of science and millions of dollars in research, like Beyond Tangy Tangerine, EFA Plus 90, and OsteoFX Plus. To order your Healthy Start Pack today, call 607-739-5595. Again, that number is 607-739-5595. Once you start taking the Healthy Start Pack, you will see and feel why our motto is 90 for life.
Imagine for a moment a radio program, the most personal of mediums, that reaches hundreds of thousands of people on more than 140 radio stations across the U.S. and around the world through the internet with podcasts and live streams. Imagine the advertising is affordable from $600 to $6,000 a month. Free Talk Live is that program. We will work with you to get clicks, calls, views, or sales. Email me at mark@freetalklive.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Free Press Publications is an independent alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary at fpp.cc, as well as weekly news in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com. The monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc and books at shop.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, take control of the airwaves, toll free. We've been talking about the Venezuelan situation, and actually Ali did a little bit of digging, as did I. Ali, you found out more about the toilet paper shortage there, and I've got a little bit more information about the money situation, which is an absolute mess, and their current inflation rate, and they're both tied together. We'll talk about that here in a moment. Toll free number is 855-450-FREE. You can also join us on Skype at username lrn.fm. Don't forget, we've got archives, so if you've missed a moment of Free Talk Live, no problem. Just go, click, download. They're yours at freetalklive.com. Plus, I just announced via our news release list, which you can go to news.freetalklive.com to sign up for our email list. I announced recently that we are now doing YouTube video archives, which some people have asked for. So we decided, all right, well, what's it going to take to do this? And turns out it's not that much more work every night. It's more work, but it's not a huge burden. You guys did it for the first time on the Sunday show last night. It's been going for about a week or two prior to that. And hopefully we'll be able to do it on a consistent nightly basis from here on out. But if you want to see the show, so like you can watch live at cam.freetalklive.com. But if you want to watch the show later on, you can now do that. Which means all the awkward freeze frame faces that we make are now going to be preserved forever.
Great.
So
don't pick your nose.
Go to YouTube.com. Go to YouTube.freetalklive.com. That'll take you right to the Free Talk Live YouTube channel, where you will find previous episodes going back a couple weeks and hopefully on into the future. So if you're used to getting archives like an hour after the show online, you're still going to get the audio quickly, but YouTube takes quite a while to process a 3-hour video block.
You're putting the whole 3-hour block on YouTube?
How many views are these things getting?
A few dozen per show so far, but we've only been doing it for a couple weeks, and we have not promoted this YouTube channel in any meaningful way up until now. So you can go get archives in video form now at youtube.freetalklive.com.
Well, there you go.
Yep, our toll-free number, 855-450-FREE, to the phones next.
Will new technologies enslave mankind or liberate us? Depends on who has the better ideas. In the book Quantum Vibe, Volume 2, Murphy, our favorite mad scientist, and his hard-drinking sidekick continue their epic mission to open a vast new frontier for humankind as they navigate complex political and corporate intrigues on a terraformed Mars and a colonized Vesta. Dark forces are plotting to steal, murder, and start an interplanetary war. Whose tech will overcome? Whose ideas will win the day? Quantum Vibe is a popular, liberty-themed science fiction adventure web comic which updates daily. Daily, you can get a new webcomic. This is amazing.
For free.
For free, yeah. Bigheadpress.com. And the latest volume with 161 full-color pages is available at Amazon.com, BarnesandNoble.com, and direct from the publisher at Bigheadpress.com.
All right, let's go to the phones and to the fun, and then more on the Venezuela situation. Nikolai is on the line in Wisconsin. You're on Free Talk Live.
Good morning. Good evening.
It's morning somewhere. Hey, what's on your mind tonight?
I'd like to talk about terrorism and Islam. I think you guys thinking that, you know, Islam is good and there's a plenty of good Muslims out there.
There are.
And so that's what I was going to talk about. Because,
okay,
like, when you do talk to any Muslim and you ask him certain questions, like, about Muhammad. Why did he sleep with the 7-year-old, or I mean 9-year-old? They will all tell you
married.
That
married. Why did he marry a 9-year-old? Right?
No, he slept with her.
Oh, and I thought this was a wife.
Right.
I believe he was married to her.
9-year-old yeah. wife. You can sleep with 9-year-old wife, right?
Well,
I mean, is that the case?
What do I think? I mean, I just want to clarify that this was the uh-huh. this was a wife.
And yes, he married her when she was 6. He slept mm-hmm. with her when she was 9.
Okay.
And I can. Show
what does that have to do
you?
With terrorism?
Well, I just want to hear.
Well, this is just one example of a person that all the Muslims want to be like. And there is a terrorism in there, and there is killings, and these guys.
There's terrorism
Muhammad,
in where?
In the religion, in the hadith that tells you a story of life.
Have you read the Quran?
Of the Muhammad. It's not. That's the thing. If a Quran would be the only thing that is Islam, that'd be half of the issue. That's
Isn't
not,
it true that there are different viewpoints within Islam?
What?
Isn't it true, like with Christianity, that there are different viewpoints and interpretations within Islam?
Within Islam?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I suppose no, not really, because... No.
The answer is yes. There are several different viewpoints.
Sunnis,
of,
Shiites, yeah.
Sorry,
Sufis.
Nikolai.
Right.
You don't know what you're talking about. Have a nice night.
It doesn't seem likely that, like, to be Muslim, you have to accept terrorism as an ideal or something. That just sounds wrong.
Or that you have to want to marry a 9-year-old or something like
yeah.
that. Sorry.
Well, I do think that, okay, so if you compare, if you're comparing and contrasting religions, right, like the story we have of Jesus... Probably better than the story we have of Muhammad. Simply,
there's a lot of good stories about Muhammad.
Yeah, but this 9-year-old wife thing is a real problem. Wouldn't you agree?
It is gross.
If you're going to hold up a dude, that yeah. dude shouldn't have married somebody at 6 and slept with them at 9. I mean, I just think that all these ancient texts really have a problem with them. I, you know, these are people's visions of God
well, just
from
let's,
a,
let's,
1,400 years ago.
I know where you're going, Mark, and just focus back briefly on Muhammad. I'm not defending everything that Muhammad did. I'm not a Muslim, but I know a thing or two about it. I've done a cursory amount of research. I read the Quran while I was in jail, so I've done that. And most people can't say that they've done that, and I've done some research beyond that. Let's remember the time frame here that we're talking about. Things were different back in those days, and certainly
sure.
the way women were treated was very different than how women are treated in society today.
It's likely that Jesus was married, and we just don't know. It's not a certainty. And most of the people that want to compare and contrast Christianity to Islam want to lead you down the primrose path. To, hey, look, Christianity's better. And, you know, these ancient texts suck. All of them. They all suck. I've got friends who are Muslims. They can make a good argument for Islam from a liberty perspective. But it doesn't take too long racking up the deaths that are put in historically, that put in the names of these religions, where you're just like, yuck, why do I care what Muhammad had to say about God? What Muhammad didn't have a pipeline or the interstate to God.
Well, actually, the story is that it was an angel.
The story's a damn lie, Ian! No, the angel Melchizedek did not visit Muhammad, unless you are some kind of...
I don't think that was the name of the angel.
It's some name. I think it begins with an M.
I thought it was Gabriel. But I could be wrong.
I could be wrong. The angel.
Maybe
no,
the translated version is Gabriel, but the other.
If
one.
You believe an angel visited Muhammad, you're either on a psychotropic trip or you need to check your premises.
But I guess the point I was trying to make, and I agree with you. I don't necessarily believe the story, but I'm just kind of telling you what the story is that, you know, he went into this cave and was delivered a message, and he did it multiple times, was delivered a message through
this
angel.
I'm going into the cave to get a message now.
Yeah, and then he...
I have no idea what the message will be when I come out.
And then,
I haven't considered this at all for the last several hours.
And he memorized the...
The angel in the cave! Nobody come in here now. There's an angel. Nobody... somebody come in the cave. The angel's going to tell me important stuff.
He memorized I don't know if they're called what they're stanzas or whatever, of the Quran and repeated them to people, and they memorized them and repeated them, and eventually somebody wrote them down.
That is amazing stuff that people were able to memorize
the entire Quran.
What this guy said. And oftentimes it was just sort of repeated over.
There's a lot of repetition in the Quran. If you read the whole thing, there's content that comes up multiple times.
Fascinating stuff. I really hate the let's compare this religion to that religion game. Okay, so if you want to call Muslims terrorists,
what you're talking about.
Well,
I mean, if you're
let's
going
say
to...
that all Christians are snake handlers. I mean, that's how ridiculous it is.
Or all Christians do the babbling thing with the talking in tongues.
There's a lot of Christians that do the comparative number of talking in tongues compared to snake handlers is a big difference.
There are crazies everywhere, I guess.
855-450 free. Share your thoughts, whether informed or not, on Free Talk Live.
Everybody wants to know, what can you buy with Bitcoins? Isn't there like a Bitcoin General Store or something? Well, yes, now there is, and it's at BitcoinGeneralStore.com. BitBrew and the Bees Brothers have teamed up to create a place where U.S. customers in the lower 48 can shop for, well, anything, with free shipping. What can you find at BitcoinGeneralStore.com? Bitcoin apparel, stickers, gifts, precious metals, physical bitcoins, coffee and honey, of course, and electronics and computer accessories. The folks at Bitcoin General Store are true Bitcoin believers who don't even use third-party payment processors. They get their inventory direct with Bitcoin and pass on the savings to you. Shop at BitcoinGeneralStore.com with confidence that you are supporting a real Bitcoin economy. You gotta see what they have to offer. Visit BitcoinGeneralStore.com today. That's BitcoinGeneralStore.com.
Self-reliance.
Survival supplies.
Survival skills.
National experts.
Get it all at the only free-to-attend national event exclusively for preppers.
This spring in Tulsa.
It's the National Preppers and Survivalist Expo.
A must-be-there event.
Presented by American Living. This massive expo will include special guests.
David Mays from Nat Geo's Doomsday Preppers.
Plus, GCN's own Dr. Joel Wallach via live video conference.
Hear Dr. Bones.
Nurse Amy. And members of the American Prepper Network,
along with many other leading national experts.
Learn life-saving tips, CPR, how to handle crisis situations,
walk through a bomb shelter, and much, much more.
Two big days, April 5th and 6th at the Tulsa Expo Square in Tulsa, Oklahoma.
That's April 5th and 6th. Doors open at 9 a.m. with absolutely free admission.
Don't miss the National Preppers and Survivalist Expo, America's largest emergency preparedness event.
Get your free tickets now.
NPSExpo.com.
That's NPSExpo.com.
House of Representatives Bill 323, the IHOP should stay open all night so we can get some pancakes act. This bill was submitted for immediate review very late last night under the provisions of the National Emergency Legislation Act.
Can we dim the lights? It's really bright.
H.R. 323 would, by federal order, require all IHOP restaurants to, quote, remain open 24 hours effective right this minute, even if some manager has to get out of bed and drive down here to start making some pancakes.
Well, we stand by the bill.
Right. We wrote it, apparently.
This bill would also require the federal government pay to build a tram or monorail or whatever connecting the Black Sheep Pub on North Capitol Street to all IHOP restaurants
in the city. I think
we
made some illustrations of that.
The bill gives the estimated cost of the tram as probably not even that much. You are wasting my time and the time of this committee.
Excuse me, I gotta go.
What? Congressman, this committee is still in session. You can't...
This is the Onion News Network.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats and the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
When I signed up for the Free State Project, I was excited by the prospect of moving somewhere with other people that had liberty as a goal. When I got here to New Hampshire, I was stunned by the great weather and the natural beauty. The Free State Project is helping to move liberty forward. Want to be involved? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org. That's freestateproject.org.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, take control here. Toll-free number 855-453. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Just drop by freetalklive.com. Hey, if you like the show and you like what we're doing here on Free Talk Live, then please become a Free Talk Live amplifier. The AMP program stands for Advertise, Market, and Promote. And the idea is to bring more people to this program, whether on the radio, with over 140 great radio stations from coast to coast. We want to expand that number. And we've done a great job recently with the AMP program, raising money to pay Daryl to be our affiliate relations person, in addition to me. So we now have two people making calls to radio stations during the daytime, which is great, and that's helped us bring more stations on board faster. But we've changed, kind of shifted gears in our AMP fundraising efforts at the moment. You can go to amp.freetalklive.com. There's more detail there, but essentially we're getting matching dollars from a few of our supporters. And the idea is that if you become a Free Talk Live amplifier for $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com, you get perks like access to the AMP-only call-in lines, the AMP-only podcast, the AMP-only Facebook group, which is a brand new, really cool perk for Free Talk Live amplifiers. You get access.
They're using it too.
They are using it, and it's great. I'm really happy to see that. And so are we. So it's like there's lots of good questions in there for us. Like, well, what are you guys doing with the AdWords? What are the keywords you're using? So we're kind of getting into those granular details there on the group. But you can get all these perks by becoming an amplifier at amp.freetalklive.com, and your AMP money is doubled. And what are we doing with that? We're trying to raise approximately $200 a month for this. We are advertising on Google AdWords and bringing new listeners to Free Talk Live, people who weren't necessarily looking for liberty-oriented talk radio, although I have an ad about that. I've got two ads running. There's one that's kind of a generic talk radio you control ad, and there's another one like 100% pro-liberty talk radio. So there's two types of ads, and they both get about the same click-through ratio, about 2%, 2+%. And so it's working already. We're already getting clicks, but we're trying to fundraise some more money to support this project. So please become a Free Talk Live amplifier and double your AMP money by going to amp.freetalklive.com and get signed up there. You can use any major credit card through PayPal or Visa or MasterCard right on the front page of this amp.freetalklive.com. Again, that's amp.freetalklive.com. Ali, you did some digging about Venezuela. We had
mentioned that...
There was a news story about the protests that are happening in the streets, the crackdown that's happening now. There have been many deaths in just the last month or two in Venezuela, and hundreds of people have been injured in these protests. And one of the reasons why people are in the streets and protesting, kind of, we've asked previously, what's going to take to get Americans out and into the streets? Well, apparently, if you lose toilet paper for any decent amount of time, that's going to get people
that's
out
enough.
Into the streets.
It is an outrage.
And that is what's happening. That's literally what's happening in Venezuela. They have a shortage of toilet paper.
It was what I had suspected. It seems to be having to do with price controls, or at least that's what businesses and some of the political opposition to the Venezuelan government says, and that there are also tight restrictions on foreign currency. I'm not exactly what that's about, Ian, but it seems like
I'll tell you more about that here in a moment. I've got details.
It says the story I'm reading from CNN says that those policies make it so that producers can't even break even on the production of toilet paper. Mm. But then the government is claiming that the private companies aren't doing their part, accusing them of hoarding their products in hopes of selling it at a higher price, which is one of the sort of, it's very helpful when the people who make toilet paper get to decide what the price of it is, not just for them in that they make more money when demand goes up, but for the consumer, because you don't have shortages. Like, I would rather pay more for toilet paper than have no toilet paper at all. And I think that's a value judgment most people would make.
At some point, you will stop paying for toilet paper. And this is really the difficulty that government controls over price have. The government can't figure out what the price of something should be. You have to have competition in the marketplace to figure out what the price of something should be. You can see you have a very difficult time. You just don't have the mechanism for feedback. So, you know, you're oftentimes business owners, people will start business, start into businesses, will think to themselves, well, what are my overhead costs? And I should just get a certain amount above that. That's fair. The marketplace doesn't care what's fair. If pencils cost 10 cents, but I decide to go in the pencil business and it cost me $1.10 to make a pencil, and I'm like, look, this is fair because this is what it cost me to make a pencil, and I need to make 10 cents.
You're in the wrong business, pal.
Right. You just can't compete. It doesn't matter. So, when you're in a monopoly situation, you can figure out how much money is the most money I can make is really the best thing you can do. So if I have the price at this, I can sell this many units. If I have it at that, I'll sell that many units. And you just kind of do the multiplication and try to figure it out. But so far, it's never really worked.
When buyers and sellers are allowed to make an agreement on price, which is what you're doing when you pay for something at the store, you're agreeing that you think that this, you know, roll of toilet paper is worth this amount of money, that whatever it is that was asked for. And so when people are able to come to an agreement and set prices independently, that's when we find out what the general market price of something actually is. When the government sets a price arbitrarily, they say, all toilet paper shall be 10 cents a roll from here on out in Venezuela. And if it's too cheap, if it's below what that market price would normally be, then somebody's going to go and just buy it all up and sell it on the black market at 10 times the rate. And if it's too expensive, then people are going to start rationing and start, you know, wiping multiple times with, you know, one ply toilet paper.
They're going to use other things.
Yeah. They'll come up with something else.
They'll figure out, they'll use fabric and rinse it off whatever.
So what's happened is that it sounds like Maduro has set some sort of price control on toilet paper that has made it unprofitable to sell the toilet paper, and anybody who has sold it has probably sold out very, very quickly because it's below market value.
Yeah, it's one of the situations where it seems like the state gets involved. Like, this isn't the only industry in which the Venezuelan government has sort of taken over and said, you're not doing an efficient enough job. We need the government to come in and make it
mess
better.
Things up.
Well, I mean, exactly. And this would talk about a perfect example of government involvement and how they screw things up. I mean, what could be this is one of the worst situations you can imagine.
Right.
I mean, it's hard to even envision not having toilet paper. We're so used to that.
But people really do believe that central control can, you know, is the best system for coming up with. Because when it comes to toilet paper, it's fair that poor people are able to get toilet paper cheaply. That's the idea here, because that's what it comes down to with healthcare. I mean, toilet paper is a necessity, just like healthcare.
Yeah.
Well, that's what you're hearing as far as Obamacare and all that stuff, is it's
same
fair
stuff
for people to get this at a reasonable price. Well, I don't know what a reasonable price is, and I don't know what you're owed exactly, but when it comes down to toilet paper, the fact is the government can't provide it. They just can't do it. We can see it in Venezuela. The price controls don't work.
So, is there more to the story?
That's basically it.
So I've got more details on the money side of this situation, because it's an important factor. There's the one factor of people not being able to easily manufacture the toilet paper in Venezuela because they have to sell it at below market rates, so why even bother? But what if they could import it? Well, importing things becomes tricky in Venezuela because of the forced the forced government-mandated price for the bolivar, which is their national currency. So here's a story that kind of addresses that from marketwatch.com and also addresses their inflation rate. It is 57.3%. This story was published on March 15th. Price inflation. I don't know if that's price inflation, Mark. But anyway, it's certainly prices do tend to inflate when you inflate the money supply. And Venezuela's inflation rate annually has climbed to 57.3% in February as the South American country has grappled with protests that weighed on the economy, the central bank reported Friday. Of course, it's the protesters' fault now that there's 57% inflation. By the way, the inflation rate in Venezuela has been outrageous for much longer than the protests have been going on. The 12-month rate in December and January hovered over just above 56% before jumping last month as protesters took to the streets nationwide. Authorities said there have been nearly 30 deaths. We already talked about that. Unrest slowed supply chains, they claim, and interrupted operations, according to the central bank's website. And President Maduro has said his government is confronting an economic war waged by Washington, D.C.
Yeah. Interesting.
And his political opposition.
Who else controls the potty paper?
Detractors of Maduro say the demonstrators have been stirred in part by the government's mismanagement of the economy, and the central bank tracked a jump of 2.4% in February versus the previous month. which represented an improvement over the 3.3% posted in January, but higher than the 1.6 registered in February of last year. That's the monthly inflation rate. The central bank didn't release February numbers for its scarcity index, a measure of basic goods out of stock, along with the inflation data as customary. In January, the scarcity index reached 28%, its highest level since the central bank launched the measure in 2005. And now they're just not releasing that number at this point.
I wonder how long after a government decides to print money or inflate its currency, does the exchange rate get, you know, changed?
Good question. Well, right now in Venezuela, they'll change the exchange rate when it's legislated. They'll tell you what the legislated number is here in a little bit and what the actual market value of the bolivar is as well, because there's a black market in currency in Venezuela now. We'll get back to that here in Hour 3 next. You take control as well. Free Talk Live.
Meowbit is free software from the Freedom Fiends that allows you to effortlessly view .bit websites. Meowbit works on all browsers. .bit is a new type of web address that's not controlled by any government or corporation. And we'll show you how to register a .bit domain today using a few cents worth of Namecoin. If anyone ever shuts down your .com website, users will still be able to get to your site using your .bit address and our free software, Meowbit. Go to meowbit.com. That's M-E-O-W-B-I-T.com.
Hey, this is Guy Fieri. Now, when your recipe calls for red peppers, chili powder, garlic, and onions, you got the start of some awesome chili and maybe some heartburn. If that's the case, roll out the Rolaids Liquid.
Don't let heartburn keep you from enjoying the things you love. New Rolaids Liquid gets you back in the action fast. Even when your worst heartburn symptoms flare up, Rolaids Liquid dual active formula coats and soothes for rapid relief. New Rolaids Liquid in your choice of mint or cherry. Use as directed.
R-O-L-A-I-D-S? Now that's how you spell relief.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Stouffer's, helping bring your family together with wholesome dinner options, even on the busiest of nights. Find dinner table ideas to bring your family together at letsfixdinner.com. To get kids involved in dinner time conversation, ask specific questions, not broad ones. Instead of what happened today at school, try what was the best thing that happened today. The more specific you are, the more they'll have to say. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 3 is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
Radio VR.
Good morning and welcome to Radio VR. We're broadcasting live from Washington, D.C. and around the world on voiceofrussia.com/US. I'm Kate Zickel. Today is Monday, March 17, 2014. Here's the news.
Radio VR News.
After a big win at the polls in favor of Russia, President Obama is rejecting the results of a vote in Crimea to secede from Ukraine. Ed Donahue has the latest.
The president told Russian President Vladimir Putin after the results came in that the vote would never be recognized by the United States. The White House says Obama told Putin the vote violates Ukraine's constitution and happened under the duress of Russian military intervention. Putin was also told to be prepared for retaliatory penalties by the U.S. Even before the results came in, the White House denounced the vote in Crimea, saying no decision should be made about the future of Ukraine without the Ukrainian government. Ed Donahue, Washington.
On the Middle East front, President Obama meets today with Palestinian leader Mahmoud Abbas as peace talks with Israel enter a crucial phase. White House correspondent Mark Smith has more.
The administration's trying to reach a framework by next month that at least outlines a future peace. But the signs of discord far outnumber any of progress. The one thing, Palestinians still reject Israel's role as a legally Jewish state. But Secretary of State John Kerry told lawmakers the lack of public concessions is not surprising.
Please remember, they're negotiating. Nobody's going to give up. I mean, you know, by the same token, Prime Minister Netanyahu doesn't stand up and say, hey, here's how I'm going to give you Jerusalem.
Meantime, it hasn't helped that Kerry's shuttle diplomacy has been slowed by the standoff with Russia over Ukraine. Mark Smith at the White House.
The mystery of Flight 370 is prompting New York Senator Charles Schumer to introduce legislation designed to prod other countries into checking the passports of airline passengers against Interpol's stolen passport database. Correspondent Julie Walker tells us why.
Two of the passengers on the missing Malaysia Airlines plane were traveling on stolen passports. It's unclear if they had any role in the plane's disappearance, but Senator Schumer wants to make sure the loophole gets closed.
When you get on a plane with a stolen passport, you're hiding something, and you're probably up to no good.
Interpol has said only three countries, including the U.S., regularly check passengers against the database. Schumer's bill would remove countries from the U.S. visa waiver program if they have not begun the process of checking international passengers against Interpol's list within 5 years. Julie Walker, New York.
A plea deal has been reached in the court-martial of a high-ranking Army officer charged with sexual assault. Correspondent Diane Kepley has the details.
In exchange for the most serious charges against him being dropped, his attorneys say General Jeffrey Sinclair will plead guilty to lesser charges. He was accused of twice forcing a female Army officer into an involuntary sex act during their three-year affair. Sinclair has agreed to plead guilty to having improper relationships with three subordinate officers, including the female captain who accused him of assault. He'll also plead guilty to adultery, which is a crime in the military. Sinclair is the former deputy commander of the 82nd Airborne Division and the highest-ranking officer to be court-martialed on sexual assault charges. I'm Diane Kepley.
Correspondent Jackie Quinn reports drones are now banned in the U.S., but the government estimates that about 7,500 small drones will be in flight within 5 years after their use is approved.
Not everyone's adhering to the U.S. ban against unmanned drones in the sky. Drones have been used to photograph the apartment buildings that collapsed in New York last week and a car crash in Connecticut. In South Korea, Japan, Australia, and other countries, drone use is becoming common. Some members of Congress are worried the U.S. will be one of the last countries to embrace the technology.
If you love chocolate, and who doesn't? A new study is going to see whether chocolate pills are good for your heart. Correspondent Carlotta Bradley has the tasty details.
A big study is being launched to see if pills containing the nutrients in dark chocolate can help prevent heart attacks and strokes. The study will be the first large test of cocoa flavanols, which in previous smaller studies improve blood pressure, cholesterol, the body's use of insulin, artery health, and other heart-related factors. A second part of the research will test multivitamins to help prevent cancer. The study will be sponsored in part by Mars, Inc., maker of M&Ms and Snickers. I'm Carlotta Bradley.
And that's the news for Radio VR in Washington. I'm Kate Zickel.
It's being called the must-have tech gadget of the year. The Samsung Apex, which hits shelves today, streams video into your left eye, internet into your right eye, and sucks your dick all at the same time. Samsung spokesman Neil Werner is projecting the biggest sales in his company's history.
Are you kidding me? This thing does everything, plus it sucks your dick, all right? And I know what you're thinking, and yes, ladies, there is a version for you that eats you out. Hang it up, Apple. We beat you the punch on this one. Samsung's got you by the balls.
In spite of the almost $1,000 price tag, customers are raving about the device.
For my career, I do need the internet and TV, and my dick sucked all the time.
I already have a TV and a girlfriend and a laptop, but to have all those in one device would be really nice.
Even a run of bad press about unsafe working conditions in the Apex factory in India have not dampened sales projections.
Yeah. Factory, switch up, blah, blah. How about you just plug your eyeball straight into the internet and get your dick sucked?
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live, we're launching into the third hour of the program. You can take control of the airwaves toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And we have Skype. You can Skype into the show at username lrn.fm. We've been talking about the Venezuelan situation. It has deteriorated further. There are now protests in the streets. There's been a crackdown on those protests. There have been people killed in these crackdowns. Over, I think, 28 people at least have perished. Over 360 have been injured. And toilet paper is a motivating factor here. That is, the lack of toilet paper is what is motivating people to get out into the streets. It's one of the things. Of course, the money situation in Venezuela is also a mess, which is a factor in why there's no toilet paper in the country, or a very, very small amount of it. So essentially there's a shortage, and it's being created by economic policies about toilet paper and price controls, as well as this ridiculous government-mandated price point for their currency. And was sharing a story from MarketWatch.com a moment ago with Ali and Mark and you, the listener. And just about to get to the detail here, they've just been kind of talking about some of the frustrations, the economic difficulties, the inflation rate. In a year, their inflation rate has been 57.3%. Last month, it was a 2.4%. February was a 2.4% increase. In January, 3.3%. So it just keeps on going. And what do you do about that? Well, the idea might be that you could trade some of your bolivars for dollars, right? Maybe, or for some other currency around the world. Of course, Bitcoin obviously is a completely different solution, but the average person in Venezuela probably not aware of that. So, you know, one of the things they can do
in a couple of years, it might be a different story. And that's one of the wonderful things about Bitcoin.
Hopefully so. It would be very interesting to see if there are any Venezuelan Bitcoin related stories. I haven't looked for that.
You probably get your head chopped off for using it.
But classically, you know, the idea would be, well, if your currency is inflating, get your money out of that currency and put it in somewhere else. But the problem is there's a mandated price from the government, and according to the story here at MarketWatch.com, the price is currently 6.3 bolivars for a dollar. Now, unfortunately, the actual price of a bolivar is, the actual price for a dollar, the amount of bolivars you get for a dollar is 80 on the black market. So bolivars are not worth, you know, as much as the government is
nobody
saying
will pay this
that they're worth.
So what if you were going on a trip to Venezuela and you wanted, you know how you can exchange dollars for the currency, like, I don't know, at the government office there, you can ask them to do the exchange. I wonder what they would charge if they would go with a Venezuelan.
Oh, yeah, they're going to go with a government rate.
Yeah, but you would want to get it on the black market where you could get 80 bolivars for the same dollar. So there's actually an interesting story here from Time.com.
Well, this is, by the way, nobody's going to give that to you. No Venezuelan's going to say, oh, yes, you get 80 bolivars for your dollar because, oh, don't worry about the government rate. This is what we really give on the black market to all Americans.
You're not going to get 80, but if you buy in the black market, you can
get more
than
the rate. You're not going to get in the black market. You're a damn tourist, Ian.
You are incorrect about that. Let me give you the story from Time.com. Vinny is in the middle of
this is why nobody visits Venezuela, is the point I'm trying to make. Nobody's going to go there and do tourist stuff because they can't get a fair rate for their dollar.
Well, if you've got the right connections, you can.
Yes, of course you can.
That's what the
black market's
all about.
Anymore.
Okay, I get what you're saying. Anyway, Vinny's in the middle of a whirlwind trip. He began in Caracas 10 days ago, has already passed through New York, Chicago, Kansas City, Dallas, Indianapolis, and Los Angeles, and is about to board a flight from Miami to Milan and on to Madrid. The 28-year-old personal trainer will be there for around 36 hours before continuing his journey on to London, Johannesburg, Doha, Tokyo,
Dallas.
It
sounds like he's just giving money to the airlines.
Lima, and finally Caracas again in just over a week's time. The entire trip, all 16 flights, cost him just $600. This is the Holy Grail, says Vinny as he boards the flight to Milan. The journey will earn him some 100,000 air miles and help re-qualify him for American Airlines' highest frequent flyer tier. When using money obtained on the black market, the cost of flights out of Venezuela can be up to 10 times less than normal market prices. Huh. A return flight from Caracas to New York can effectively cost $150, to London, $300, and Dubai, $500. The reason? Currency controls brought in by Hugo Chavez in 2003.
So this is actually trading for another currency, which is air miles. Air miles are a currency. You can, buy and trade them. So essentially what he's doing is he's renting out his body by sitting in one of these seats over this period of time, and he's getting, trading these, he's traded dollars for on the black market for the bolivars, which he's now trading, washing essentially and turning them into airline miles, which he may or may not sell in the future. So it's an interesting ploy. I don't know why you'd want to be in these places for like 8 hours. I mean, what are you going to do at 8 hours in Lima?
I have no idea, Mark. See a prostitute? I don't know. Do a black market currency deal?
No idea. I don't know why that came up.
The reason, if you've got a short period of time and you're an international man, some people do that stuff. Anyway, currency controls severely limit the amount of foreign currency that Venezuelans are legally able to purchase from the government. Under the official exchange rate, $1 buys 6.3 bolivars, the local currency named for Latin American independence hero Simon Bolivar. But the controls have created a black market on which greenbacks sell for more than 10 times as much. This week, authorities brought in a second exchange rate, essentially a devaluation of just over 40%, though the government calls use of the D word enemy spin, in an attempt to curb economic distortions. But economists are doubtful the move will satiate the high demand for dollars. The result is that in socialist Venezuela, those with access to foreign currency can propel themselves into the 1%, flying around the world and living in five-star hotels, while locals earning in bolivars battle one of the most expensive economies on the planet.
So can you use dollars in Venezuela at most shops? Because in some countries, you can just use dollars.
I don't know if you can legally use dollars in Venezuela in most shops, but that doesn't mean you wouldn't be able to use them.
I mean, do they, publicly accept dollars if you go to, a convenience store in Venezuela?
Probably they do, but they're going to give you an exchange rate that is basically whatever they want to give you.
Okay, mm-hmm. Right.
See, well, okay, so I was in Belize, and in Belize, they have this exchange rate of 2-1, and you could spend your dollars there, and they'd give you back Belizean dollars in change. And it was relatively easy to do because their dollars pegged to the U.S. dollar. But I have no clue what Belizeans. I know that there was a discount for locals at one of the restaurants I went to. I don't know what that discount was. So they kind of have this. It's a second set of books, as it were. So if you come into my store as an American and I'm in the convenience store, I'm going to size you up. I'm going to say, right. How savvy does she look?
Mm-hmm.
Well, it looks like the exchange rate is, what is it, 6.5?
Official exchange rate, 6.3.
6.3 is what the exchange rate is. Here you go. I'm going to change off. And I have just made a whole bunch.
Right, because in your head as a store owner, you know what you can get for a dollar on the black market. You've got the connections to where we know that it's up to 80 bolivars per dollar, but let's say your connection will only give you 50, right? So you know in your head that, gringo coming in has a dollar. They're going to buy something. I can get 50 bolivars for that. And maybe you'll give them a better rate than 6.3 if the person is savvy.
Right. So she says she takes her stuff. She's ready to leave. I'm like, whoa. I'll give you 10.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
10-1.
Right. Because you would want the dollars more because they have a better exchange rate.
Exactly. But whether it's legal or not to accept dollars is another question.
Okay.
I don't know the answer to that question. I suspect it's not legal.
I suspect you're an enemy of the revolution, which is, by the way, there's a revolution going on, so it's interesting how revolutions hate the revolutions.
So anyway, if you have access to foreign currency in Venezuela, you're doing very, very well. But if, on the other hand, you live in Venezuela and all you have access to are the bolivars, you're having a very difficult time struggling to find and afford basics such as cooking oil, chicken, and toilet paper. Fed by inflation, the divide has grown rapidly in tandem with the expansion of the black market. Those with dollars or any hard currency are able to take advantage of the thriving black market by buying local money either in shady street deals or in white-collar transactions with willing brokers by transferring their money between international bank accounts. In this game, trust is the key, says one illegal broker sitting in an expensive hotel.
This is why I love Bitcoin. It's a trustless currency.
We'll come back with more here in moments about the fascinating results and horrifying results of the currency controls in Venezuela, which are resulting in people not being able to use toilet paper on a regular basis. 855-450-FREE. If you have been there and you'd like to share your experience, would love to hear from you, or you can take control and bring up whatever's on your mind here on Free Talk Live.
I want to share something important that will not only improve your life, but the lives of many others as well. And all you need to do is drink coffee. I'm not talking about harmful store-bought or chain coffee. No, this is truly the best of the best coffee. We've partnered with Camano Island Coffee Roasters to offer BuzzBox. With every purchase, 10% goes towards our efforts to give the gift of human freedom by providing at least 100 microfinance loans via World Vision. So literally, just one cup at a time, you're having an impact and helping helping make a difference in the world. And one sip will have you buzzing to family and friends. To prove just how good it is, we're giving a free pound of coffee to everyone in the audience. All you do is cover shipping. Go to coffee.freetalklive.com. BuzzBox Coffee is organic, so it contains no pesticides or toxins. It's shade grown, so less acidity and no heartburn. It's top 1% Arabica grade and gives people the opportunity to own their own coffee farms. Join us in making a huge impact at coffee.freetalklive.com.
On the average, Americans work between 45 to 50 years, hoping to build up enough wealth to retire and live out their golden years. Unfortunately, with taxation, the rising cost of food, energy, housing, and medical, many retirees are forced to live below the poverty line. Is this a flaw-free enterprise, or is our monetary unit we call the Federal Reserve Note forcing us into perpetual debt, ensuring inflation and higher taxes? These questions and more can be answered by reading G. Edward Griffin's book, The Creature from Jekyll Island. Congressman Ron Paul states, it's what every American needs to know about central bank power. A gripping adventure into the secret world of international banking cartel. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. I will give a silver dollar from the early 1900s to anyone who purchases this book. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order a copy today. It's critical that the public be made aware of the system. Call and order your copy today at 1-800-686-2237. That's 1-800-686-2237.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more.
It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
If you want to move to the Free State and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin, any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, take control here, toll free. More on the way about Venezuela's money situation. It's pretty scary stuff there. If you are somebody who lives in Venezuela and you don't have access to foreign currency, you are having a very difficult time getting toilet paper, among other things. Apparently chicken is also in short supply there. Of course, government controls on price haven't been helping. The price of the products haven't been helping, and they're also trying to control the price of the money in the country, which of course doesn't work because the black market exists and will always work in contradiction to the government demands. We'll give you more of sort of the effects of what this means here in a few moments, and you can share your thoughts as well at 855-450-FREE and join us online at freetalklive.com. We've got listening choices there. Live streams, there's broadband, midband, and narrowband versions of the show. They're available around the clock over at listen.freetalklive.com. Get a list of our over 140 radio stations coast to coast and beyond, our satellite listening choices, as well as a webcam and listen lines that allow you to call from any phone that can dial long distance. Get tuned in over at listen.freetalklive.com.
Whether it's an automobile accident or an encounter with the police, driving is the most dangerous thing that we do. That's why you need a dash cam to protect you. FreedomCam.net has a new dash cam with many features to be your ultimate witness. It has the front-facing camera, a camera facing the inside of the cab with a microphone. It has GPS recording for your driving route and speed. It has a G-force meter to record an accident. It has it's password protected with an SD card, and it has an LCD display showing a video in real time, or you can play back the recorded footage. All these features for a new lower price, and they accept Bitcoin. You can check it out at dashcam.freetalklive.com. I'm excited about this new product because of its lower price. It's going to open us up to other people. Mm-hmm. The one feature it doesn't have is the infrared camera, but frankly, in a traffic stop, you can turn on the overhead light in your car,
there you go. Yep.
And then you're covered. Go. Plus, the audio is really more important than the video in that circumstance.
Certainly true.
So it's also useful at night because of whatever happened as far as an accident goes. You're using your headlights. The infrared's only for the inside of the cab. Right. So it's freedomcam.net for the new exciting Freedom Cam. And
they still have the other one too.
They do.
Yep.
And it's good. It's a good device. I have it. What I think is great about it is it comes on when you just don't think about it. You install it stop thinking about it.
It's true. All right. So freedomcam.net. We continue here with more about Venezuela and the socialist rule of Nicolas Maduro after Hugo Chavez and some of the nationalization that's been going on there, the price controls. And what is the result of when the government says our bolivar, you can get the current exchange rate for the bolivar is 6.3 to one U.S. dollar, meaning that if you give one U.S. dollar over to the official government exchange locations, they will give you 6.3 bolivars, whereas in the black market, you can get up to 80 bolivars for one U.S. dollar. And what does that mean to the people living there? Well, if you've got access to foreign currency, according to the story at time.com, you're doing pretty well because you can shop the black market and you can get good exchange rates if you've got dollars. But if you're somebody who's getting paid in bolivars and you're living in kind of the bolivar world, it can be very, very difficult to live life. And so they give some more examples of this. They are talking to an illegal broker sitting in an expensive Caracas hotel invite-only lounge. He says he earns several thousand dollars a month in fees and commissions, buying and selling what he says is a couple of million dollars every year. Clients will call him in order to obtain local money or to ask him to pay for flights and hotels directly in local currency, just as wealthy clients of invite-only charge cards, such as American Express's Black Card, use its concierge service. In stark contrast, the minimum wage here is equivalent to $519 U.S. dollars per month at the official rate, but around $50 at the black market rate.
Wow.
At Caracas's airport, Linger Tiapa sells magazines and snacks. The 39-year-old earns $52 per month at the black market rate. She says, "It's madness. The government has no idea how much we need to spend on food. I have to find other ways to make money, like selling my clothes." A middle-class professional may earn around four times Tiapa's salary. These figures make Venezuela, simultaneously, one of the most expensive and one of the cheapest countries in the world. Takeout noodles.
It's amazing, isn't it?
Takeout noodles can cost $30 or $3, depending on whether you have access to local currency or U.S. dollars. A night at a five-star Marriott hotel costs $700 or $70. It's the same principle that allows Vinny, who has access to U.S. dollars, to fly so cheaply.
Right, and Vinny's probably a local who now works in the United States, mm-hmm. and so he goes back and manages to make this work. I doubt a tourist is going to be able to pull this off, though. You're going to have to be a pretty savvy negotiator to find these black market deals.
Yeah, I wonder how you do these deals, like where you find them.
She's got to know people. It's the black market. How do you find marijuana?
People that won't stab you and take your money, right?
Yeah.
Wait, would it be like a drug deal or something?
As it was said here, there are shady, black market questionable deals with who knows who. And then there are also more of the upscale kind of brokers, black market dealers for the rich. So yes, there's the whole range of options there in the black market. Ricardo Cusano, who heads the Conceturismo Tourism Board here, estimates that 30% of airline seats are being taken up by foreigners. People outside are buying a ticket into Venezuela and then, when here, purchasing a ticket to their final destination using the black market. The currency controls are far from ideal for airlines, according to the International Air Transport Association. Airlines are awaiting $3.3 billion, which is locked up in local currency in Venezuela. The government, under pressure from airlines, has begun to exchange some of this for cash, fuel, and bonds. The IATA spokesman described the situation as unacceptable and frankly unfair. Owing to high demand, flights have become increasingly hard to come by in recent months.
I'm going to cancel that flight.
Rafael Ramirez, head of Venezuela's state oil company, remember, they nationalized the oil business years ago. The Minister of Oil and Vice President of Economic Affairs said this week that in the future, airlines would begin to receive their money at the newly announced second exchange rate, which could lower the differential between the exchange rates that fuels Vinny's cheap flights. The move will not affect the outstanding $3.3 billion, and the new rate will be determined by weekly auctions and is expected to be initially around 11 bolivars per dollar. So the Venezuelan government has one exchange rate for the people they want to give a bonus to, and another exchange rate for the people that they just don't care about, apparently.
Seems so fair.
The current official rate of 6.3 bolivars to the dollar will be reserved only for state-run companies in certain vital sectors. I'm not going to descend into a debate as to whether this is a devaluation or not, said Ramirez. With the news, the price of the dollar on the black...
I'm not going to debate about financial currency. We hand this... with financial policy, we hand this hand this down, and you people suck it up or else.
With the news of the second price, the price of the dollar on the black market rose to 12.5 times the official rate, making common scams taking advantage of the differential between the exchange rates even more lucrative. Some business visitors here are paid expenses in U.S. dollars at the official rate, even though they obtain their local currency on the black market. One young European business consultant who asked not to be named was able to pay off his entire student loan after a month's work in Venezuela, getting paid in U.S. dollars.
So here's the moral: is if you work for a big company that has, you know, subsidiaries in Venezuela, get transferred there.
There's more coming up here in moments. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And you can take control of the airwaves. Still coming up, the 81-year-old. This could be your grandmother, who's been put in jail because of a pet violation. We'll tell you what sort of violation here in moments, and you can also take control of the airwaves on Free Talk Live.
If you owe the IRS back taxes, listen carefully. Sweeping changes to IRS policies will help more people than ever eliminate their tax debts once and for all. And now I can help you reduce or eliminate your tax debts and end your tax nightmare. Hi, I'm Dan Pilla. I've helped thousands of people reduce and eliminate tax debts they couldn't pay. And after more than 30 years of experience dealing with the IRS, I can tell you there's no such thing as a hopeless tax case. And with the IRS's new policies, it's easier than ever to put your tax debt behind you once and for all. Call now at 800-346-6829 to learn how I can help you. You know your IRS debt will not go away by itself, but you don't have to live in fear anymore. Call 800-346-6829. Learn how I can help you eliminate wage and bank levies, release tax liens, and negotiate a settlement with the IRS that will put your tax nightmare behind you forever. Call 800-34-NO-TAX or go to taxhelponline.com. That's taxhelponline.com.
The Shire Free Church offers a sanctuary to those seeking an escape from state churches.
The Shire Free Church is an interfaith, diverse group of people that may not share identical theological beliefs. As a member in or minister of the Shire Free Church, you are a sovereign individual and may be the faith of your choice.
We don't claim to have all of the answers.
We are open to all peaceful people.
We want to learn from each other.
What unifies the Shire Free Church and its diverse members is peace,
love,
and liberty. There are many paths to God, one for every individual.
The Shire Free Church does not define a specific path beyond those parameters that must be your foundation.
Peace as your way.
Love as your guide.
And liberty as your light.
Learn more at church.shiresociety.com.
That's church.shiresociety.com.
Every day you make investment decisions. When you do business with and hold U.S. dollars, you make an investment in the soundness of the moral philosophy and the potential longevity of the United States hegemony. People who claim a monopoly on violence around the world. If this is the investment that you want to make, please keep listening to LRN.FM. If not, Stop using their currency. Use bitcoins. Get educated. WeUseCoins.com. The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at lrn.fm.
So we've been talking about the Venezuelan currency controls and the effects of what happens when a government sets this arbitrary rate of what, you know, how many bolivars in this case you can get for a dollar, U.S. dollar. What does that mean? Well, as you'll find out coming up here, it actually means if you've got the right connections, you can do pretty well. In fact, you can get paid to go to the doctor. We'll explain that one here in a moment. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Now, ProXPN is a global virtual private network. They don't have any locations in Venezuela for their servers, probably for good reason, but they do have several locations around the globe that allow you to connect to these sites, and then they encrypt your connection to those servers. It's a global virtual private network. Encrypted, meaning that your internet service provider will have no idea what you're doing anymore. Right now, they're probably logging everything that you do. That is your ISP. They're taking a log of all your websites you're visiting, all the search terms that you're entering, and keeping those logs for up to 5 years. So if you want to stop that from happening, just go to proxpn.com/FTL and get started with ProXPN tonight. There is a free account, but you're going to want to get their premium account where there's unlimited bandwidth. You have no limitations on the services that you can run, so you can do torrenting with their premium account, which means you can privately torrent through ProXPN. Again, go to proxpn.com/FTL. Again, it's encrypted, and you can select with their premium account which worldwide server you want to connect to. You want to make it look like you're in Singapore? Go ahead and connect to the Singapore server. How about Prague or the Netherlands or London? And there's some in the United States as well. So you can select your server. You can also protect yourself from being blocked. So there's certain countries like China or Australia that have restrictions on websites you can't visit, search terms you can't enter. Well, if you've got ProXPN on your laptop, your handheld device, or your desktop, you can get to all of those places. ProXPN.com/FTL. Go and get signed up and get started tonight. That's ProXPN.com/FTL. Get 20% off by using our discount code FTL20. And that 20% off is the price of their premium account. And it applies whether you do it monthly or annual. If you do it annual, you can break the price down to $5 a month with code FTL20 at ProXPN.com/FTL. Save even more when you pay for that annual plan with Bitcoin. And you get a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. ProXPN.com/FTL, promo code FTL20. So this Venezuelan situation kind of giving you more information about what does it mean? What happens when there's an official exchange rate that the government arbitrarily sets versus a black market exchange rate? In this case, the difference is tremendous. It's more than 10 times. In fact, recently it went up to 12 and a half times as much that you can get for a U.S. dollar on the black market in Venezuela as compared through the legitimate channels. It's 6.3 to 1 bolivars to dollars through the official channels. But if you know the right people and you got the black market connections, you can get up to 80 bolivars per dollar.
Well, and so what this essentially means is if you can get paid in U.S. dollars and go to Venezuela on a regular basis, or you live in Venezuela, plenty of people getting paid in dollars living in Venezuela.
Can live very, very well.
Well, it's your paycheck is multiplied by 12 times.
Mm-hmm.
If your paycheck was multiplied by, say, 10 times, imagine for a second the paycheck that you get on a weekly or biweekly basis having an extra zero in front of the decimal place. That's going to be a pretty good paycheck.
Mm-hmm.
Now, that's only if you have these connections where you can get the proper exchange, right?
Well, okay, so what you're talking about when you say proper, you mean the black market exchange
yes,
rate?
Yes, like if you go to the Venezuelan exchange rate office,
you're going to get a crappy.
Then you're going to get a bad deal.
Yeah.
You'd have to use the black market in order to get this really great deal.
And you're going to want to shop around because the black market rates are going to differ. So, you know, what is the range? I don't know, you might get 40 instead of 80, depending on who you know.
Right, if you're willing to take the biggest risks, you're going to get the best exchange rate.
And how much are you trading? I'm sure there's a bulk, you know, if you're doing it in bulk, you're getting a better price.
But if you're, you know, not willing to take the largest risk, you're still going to get a great exchange rate. Imagine that paycheck that you get on a weekly and biweekly basis multiplied times 5 times.
Not too shabby. So here's another way this works out. A young business consultant who asked not to be named was able to pay off his entire student loan after a month's work in Venezuela. Those with foreign health insurance plans that pay out in foreign currency are able to make more than a tenfold profit on their claims. Here's how it works. For example, a visit to the doctor can turn a profit of $115. When's that ever happened for you when you go to the doctor? This is because an appointment costs around 800 bolivars, which is noted on the claim form. The insurance company then converts this at the official rate.
At the official rate, right.
And pays out $127. However, if the patient had initially converted the dollars on the black market to pay for the appointment, the actual cost of the visit would have been around $13. So meaning that when you go to the visit, you convert your dollars to bolivars on the black market, take that money, pay the 800 bolivars, which cost you, you know, 10 bucks, essentially.
Mm-hmm.
And then you file the insurance claim. The insurance company has to exchange at the official rate. Mm. So then they send you $127. Subtract your 10 or 13 bucks that you paid out originally for the situation, and you've just profited $115 on a trip to the doctor.
Wow.
You know, that's really, it goes to show how messed up the system is.
It's crazy.
But that's not how, I mean, like, I wouldn't go to the doctor every day because of this.
Well, according to the story here, there are people who have become hypochondriacs. There's more.
Well, their company is, their company should get rid of them then. This is somebody who's spending their day going to the doctor instead of doing work for the company.
Well, whether they're, it's not real clear if we're talking about health insurance that a company is providing versus just personal health insurance.
Okay.
But the patient, if the patient had initially, with such arbitrage, an MRI scan can net a profit of around $500. A week-long stay in the hospital can be even more lucrative, bringing in more than $10,000. Mm. This has turned a few foreigners here into hypochondriacs. It's not only foreigners loaded with hard currency that can benefit, however. Locals can partake in an arbitrage process known as raspao, or the scrape. Venezuelans can claim a limited amount of foreign currency annually at the now lower official rate from the government. After jumping various bureaucratic hurdles, they are allocated the dollars on a credit card. The raspao involves flying out of Venezuela and essentially obtaining a cash advance on the money, bringing it back in, and then selling it on the black market.
Okay.
This exchange rate magic, says Angel Garcia Banks, an economics professor at the Central University of Venezuela, allows people to travel abroad for free. Alberto Ramos, a senior Latin American analyst at Goldman Sachs, is reminded of the Soviet Union. He says those that have the right connections and privileged access to hard currency at the official rate can do extremely well, he says. Critics of the government say that it is the biggest beneficiary. In a stealth telephone recording leaked by critics here in May, a voice said to be a pro-government television presenter, Mario Silva, says that those in government are attempting to steal as much as possible before the Chavez regime crumbles.
And that's what what's going to happen. You know, Chavez is dead. Maduro doesn't have the personality to keep this together. Chavez was essentially, you know, just another socialist dictator, and he was able to keep this going. He probably would have been able to keep it going longer than Maduro, but nobody can keep this going on forever. Mm-hmm. I love the Margaret Thatcher quote, not to say that I revere this woman in any way, but that, you know, the problem with socialism is sooner or later you run out of other people's money. And that's the problem. This crap doesn't work. You can't just keep on stealing from people and get productivity out of them.
Did Maduro run on a socialist platform? Does anyone know?
Oh, yeah.
Yes, he did.
Critics see the scams as inevitable and a result of tight controls. A few opportunistic characters emerge and end up profiting from the disadvantaged position that the general public is put into. So beyond all these examples of these people working the system, there's millions more who are getting screwed. I mean, that on a daily basis, living in absolute poverty as a result of these currency controls. The idea behind the currency controls was to curb inflation and capital flight. Annual inflation at the end of 2013 stood at 56.2%. It's now up to 57.3%. And some $163 billion was deposited abroad in the third quarter of that year, according to Ramos. Although he lands extremely tired and jet-lagged in Madrid, Vinny understands that his personal gain is at the expense of Venezuela as a whole. This is the guy who's jetting around the world and making money, essentially, on the currency exchanges in the black market. He says, "It just so happens that I benefit with flights," but he acknowledges the country continues to take a toll.
Yeah.
We'll continue here in moments. Your grandmother possibly arrested for what? Some sort of pet violation. She's going to jail. We'll tell you what happened here in moments on Free Talk Live.
The following is an important free offer for smokers only. The makers of Victor, the world's most advanced e-cigarette, have just authorized the release of free starter kits to all smokers who call in the next 10 minutes. Valued at $99, these Victor starter kits are available for free, but only while supplies last. To guarantee your free kit, call in the next 10 minutes, 1-800-564-6941. The revolutionary Victor design creates only water vapor. There is no foul-smelling smoke and no unhealthy tar. This allows individuals to enjoy the nicotine they love without restriction, no matter where they are. The financial advantages over cigarettes are considerable as well. It is estimated that the average smoker can save hundreds of dollars a month with Victor. Again, free Victor starter kits are now available to any smoker who calls in the next 10 minutes. This is a radio-only offer not available in stores, so call now for your free kit. 1-800-564-6941. 1-800-564-6941. 1-800-564-6941.
You've been lied to by corrupt Washington politicians and the Wall Street propaganda machine. My name is Brett Kitchen, and I want to give you a free copy of my Inc. magazine best-selling book, Safe Money Millionaire, because Wall Street's 401k and other investment plans have failed millions of Americans. After losing 35% in my IRA in the crash several years ago, I said enough. Since then, I've discovered an IRS-approved way to safely grow my money up to 12 to even 17%, cut taxes dramatically, but also have my money protected when the next crash comes. Call now to talk with a specialist to discover this little-known strategy to potentially build $1 million tax-free retirement income, get potential 12 to 17% returns, and never lose when the next crash hits. Call 888-885-8820 and discover this tool that people like Walt Disney and JCPenney used to safely grow rich. Plus, get one of just 97 free books left. We even cover shipping and handling. Call 888-885-8820. 888-885-8820. Again, that's 888-885-8820.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
Immigrating to the Shire was easy. I was instantly plugged into a community of individuals who also care about peace, liberty, and justice, and are willing to do something about it.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com. You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The Listen Lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Moments remain here, but enough time for you with your thoughts if you dial in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. With you tonight, Ian here.
Allie.
And Mark.
And don't forget, you can join us online. You can shop with Free Talk Live. You can help us out by going to shop.freetalklive.com, and you can buy all kinds of stuff there through the links to Amazon. There's Amazon US, Amazon Canada, and Amazon UK. You just click into the right one for you and get your shopping taken care of. Free Talk Live gets a cut of the purchase price at shop.freetalklive.com. And our toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. I promised you the story, been teasing it all night, about what could be your grandmother. She's someone's actually great-grandmother. She's 81 years old, according to the story at WJZ in Hartford County, Maryland. She's been placed behind bars for a pet violation, what is described as a minor pet violation, committed nearly a year ago. The Hartford County woman says she tried paying thousands of dollars in fines, but couldn't afford them. As Gigi Barnett explains, the senior citizen says her punishment doesn't fit the crime. Mary Magdalene Root's small dogs are her constant companions, so much so that the 81-year-old widow spent two nights at the Hartford County Detention Center fighting to keep them. I never had a crime, she says. Never. Not even a traffic ticket.
As evidenced by the fact that she calls it having a crime.
Back in May, Root says her pet somehow got loose from her yard several times.
Several times. I mean, it sounds like she's done a poor job of sort of managing her puppies, right? These are small dogs.
Yep. And they're going to get loose from
things.
Which
I don't like it when people who take responsibility for animals can't control them, especially if it was like a rabid dog or something like that.
Well, those rabid dogs are pretty rare. What these dogs?
Well, I just didn't mean rabid. That would mean they have rabies. Okay,
a violent dog
is what I mean to say.
Yeah, these little dogs. It's likely they don't weigh much more than 15 pounds, from what I've seen.
A neighbor, a busybody neighbor, took pictures of the dogs running down the street and snitched on her to animal control.
They were probably sick of the dogs getting out. I don't know how many times the dogs got out, but I'd like to think that this was a sort of a reasonable situation. It's like, good Lord, what's going on over there? That lady just can't handle these dogs. I'm going to, you know, take some pictures and report it to the proper authorities, having no idea what the end result would be.
So, I guess you could claim you didn't know what the end result would be when you called the government on somebody, but we certainly know what the end result is, and this story is showing you what the end result is. When you call the government on somebody, the end result can be you go to jail or worse, you know, or murder. In this case, she wasn't killed by the government agents. They did force her into a jail cell. They slapped her first, though, with a $7,000 fine. But when you don't put money in their hands when they demand it,
$7,000.
Jail is what waits for you in the background. And maybe a more neighborly way to handle something like this would be to go to her house, if you know where the dogs are coming from, to go over to her house and talk to her about her animals getting out. And ask her, you know, if there's anything that can be done to help fix the fence or whatever it is. Because, you know, they're probably digging under the fence. It's probably something simple like that. Or she's not latching the gate. You know, there's only a couple ways the dogs are going to get out.
Something was certainly occurring. But so, I would say that, you know, some people, you know, they just don't consider a problem to be a problem until the consequences of that problem smack them straight in the face. Mm-hmm. I don't know what it's like for Mary Margaret here, but I mean, you know, some people it's that way.
Mary Magdalene,
excuse me.
She says, I'm struggling to pay my house taxes. I couldn't pay the fine. It's a different thing when you leave your dogs out and you don't care, but I do care, she said. But when the cancer survivor failed to show up at court on her doctor's orders, a judge had Root arrested. She was booked, fingerprinted, and issued a striped jumpsuit. She waited to see a judge in a cell without her cancer medication. She says, I sort of clutched my Bible and was crying and went to sleep.
That's too sad.
Root's defense attorneys asked the judge to let the senior citizen go. She had no previous criminal history, and she's in failing health. The judge said no. Instead, he ordered her to pay a $2,500 bail, and if she was able to pay it and get out, then no animals would be allowed back on her property. She gave me the works, the lady says. I feel like I'm a criminal, but yet I don't feel like I've done anything. And you're right, lady. You haven't hurt anyone else.
Her dogs got out on multiple occasions.
If the dogs had destroyed someone's property, then maybe...
That would be a different story, wouldn't
it? Right, then maybe there would be...
She could talk about
restitution. Sure.
$7,000 fine for dogs getting out is outrageous.
I think the real thing about this is that you're right, Mark. I don't think that the neighbor who called animal control expected these results. I don't think that they would have had it that way if it was in their hands. What happens next?
Well, people need to realize what happens when they call the government
on
somebody.
That you can't control the outcome, that you might not get a reasonable response to whatever the complaint is.
Sure, a reasonable response would have been, look, ma'am, if this keeps on happening, we're going to have to do something about it. And it could be a fine of, you know, up to $500.
And it's too bad that you can't trust police officers to handle scenarios where, you know, like I know that it would be more neighborly just to go to your, you know, whoever you're having a problem with and say, you know, I don't like that you're doing this. Could you change it?
Help the old lady fix her fence or something, right?
Something like that. That would be, seems like that would be more beneficial for everyone. But, you know, in a lot of cases, like, have you ever had a neighbor that you're just uncomfortable being around and that you frankly just don't like you would prefer not to interact with that person and critiquing something about their, you know, say they argue all the time with each other. People can get defensive if you go over and say, can you keep it down?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, they can certainly do that.
But you should try that
first.
I
had a neighbor who was defensive about a dog. You know, I had some renters move into my house. I didn't have a problem with the dog going poop on the lawn. It never bothered me. Mm-hmm. But, you know, I'd just go out and clean it up whenever I happened to have the opportunity. It didn't matter to me. I liked the dog. But I had some renters move in, and they're like, I don't want this dog pooping on the front lawn. The next-door neighbor's like, well, tough.
Wow.
I mean, you know, that was the attitude.
And, you know, if you call the police, then that just seems like such an over-response because we know how that can go. If you called the police on your neighbor's dog, then they might go and shoot it. That's not what you want.
There's odds are good. What did I hear? There's like a dog shot in the United States by the police every 98 seconds. I don't know where that number came from, but I've heard that. I've heard about that. But anyway, back to the story. So what happened? Well, again, she's in jail essentially on a contempt charge. Because she didn't show up to court, she claims because the doctor told her something or other about that.
Just so you know, the doctor's note isn't going to do it.
Yeah. So when you're put in jail on a contempt charge, they can hold you there as long as they want. So she got out after the second night or on the second night because someone else paid her bond. A good Samaritan showed up and paid the $2,500 bond in this case. Otherwise, who knows how long she would have been held in there. She says there are some very nice people out there, but then there are some people who are so stuck on the strictness of the law. I don't know whether that needs to be looked at, she said. But now she can't go back to her home of 44 years. Under the judge's orders, the dogs aren't allowed, and Root says she can't give them up. I love them, she said. I was planning on coming down on the dogs, but my dogs, they keep my company, and I love them. I'm not sure what she means when she said she was planning on coming down on them. Root says she's had, that's the woman's last name, says she's had an outpouring of support from people in the community. In fact, there's a petition asking lawmakers to make cases like this a little more lenient for senior citizens. Root said, I don't know if it'll ever be.
Everybody's dog gets out.
Yeah.
Right. I don't know. The difficulty here is that I kind of understand the neighbor's position, but they apparently, from the story as I'm reading it, and it's clearly a biased story. I mean, you can say, you know, the the way they paint this gal, it clearly seems one-sided. But they got pictures of one incident where the dogs got out one time, and she was fined $7,000. I'd like to know if all those facts are true, but it's what it sounds like from the story.
Well, the claim is the dogs have been out multiple times.
Yes, but they don't have evidence of that.
We don't know how many police calls there have been.
No evidence of that. I mean, you know, are there pictures?
I don't know. We don't know if there have been previous calls to the police. But anyway, she says, I don't know if I'll ever be the same. I can't pull myself back. She says she was taking care of her daughter's four dogs at the time of her arrest. And the Hartford District Judge ruled that Root cannot keep her dogs on her property until the case is decided.
Well, I'd talk to the next door neighbors is what I'd do.
See if they want to keep the dogs?
Yeah.
So there you go. That's the latest for you there. I want to also share with you about ManVentureOutpost.com. If you're looking for camping, hunting, survival, or shooting gear, go check out ManVentureOutpost.com. They've got the best prices on knives, scopes, binoculars, ammunition, laser sights, tactical flashlights, fish finders, optics, firearm accessories, archery, air guns, holsters, water purification, tents, apparel, and boating equipment. ManVentureOutpost.com is family-owned, and they've got great prices, so go and see for yourself. Get it, and get it quick. From ManVentureOutpost.com. That's ManVentureOutpost.com. Check out more of Allie on her show, ALP. It is weekly, and the archives are available via podcast and direct download at ALPShow.com. Of course, plenty of Free Talk Live archives await you at FreeTalkLive.com, as well as the next episode of Free Talk Live coming up in 21 hours from now, 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern Time, 7 days a week. Join us online in the meantime at FreeTalkLive.com, and have a great night.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Well, George, you can go this way.
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring signs into the rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who do you think you
excuse
are?
Excuse me.
There is no video or audio allowed in this office.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't going to make...
Wait a minute.
Now.
Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running?
Because you scared me!
What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no. That's the sound of the men
working on the chain. Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
Are you looking for camping, hunting, survival, or shooting gear? ManVentureOutpost.com carries the name brands you want at the lowest prices. Ammunition, knives, firearm accessories, archery, air guns, scopes, binoculars, laser sights, tactical flashlights, fish finders, and boating equipment. ManVentureOutpost.com is family-owned and has the lowest prices. Go check it for yourself. Get it quick. Get it from ManVentureOutpost.com.
Now buy firearms at ManVentureOutpost.com. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Liberty Conspiracy is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, March 17th, 2014. Silver is trading at $21.27 per ounce. Gold is worth $1,378 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $620. Voters in Crimea went to the polls yesterday and voted overwhelmingly in support of joining the Russian Federation. Antiwar.com reports, the White House insisted the referendum was contrary to Ukraine's constitution and said the international community would never recognize the results. According to the Ukrainian Defense Ministry, a truce has been agreed to with Russia's Black Sea Fleet in the Crimean area for the next week. During the truce, the two sides will not engage in hostilities towards one another, and Russia has agreed not to contest the control of Ukrainian military bases in the Crimean Peninsula. It's likely not to last long, as Crimeans voted yesterday to continue their secession from Ukraine and are seeking to join the Russian Federation. Many of Ukraine's troops in the peninsula defected to Crimea in the early stages of the secessionist protest, but some bases have remained under Ukrainian control. According to officials, the truce is in effect until Friday, and Ukraine will use that opportunity for a replenishment of reserves. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Amagi Metals. When you purchase gold or silver from Amagi Metals using my affiliate link, gold.fppradio.com, you help fund FPP Radio News. Amagi Metals offers beautiful gold and silver rounds and ingots at great prices. Amagi Metals also accepts Bitcoin, Litecoin, and Dogecoin, allowing you to convert your cryptocurrencies into precious metals. Shop Amagi Metals online at gold.fppradio.com. That's gold.fppradio.com. The Guardian reports, hours before the beginning of Boston's annual St. Patrick's Day parade yesterday, the city's mayor announced that he would not take part because organizers banned gay groups from participating. Mayor Marty Walsh said, "As mayor of the city of Boston, I have to do my best to ensure that all Bostonians are free to participate fully in the civic life of our city. Unfortunately, this year, the parties were not able to come to an understanding that would have made that possible." In registering his disappointment at the dispute, the mayor noted that so much of our Irish history has been shaped by the fight against oppression. Walsh's decision came after the failure of a campaign by Mass Equality, an LGBT rights group, to persuade the South Boston Allied War Veteran Council, which organizes the parade, to allow gay veterans to openly take part. Mass Equality requested that its members be allowed to carry banners and signs identifying themselves as gay. The Veterans Council would only permit them to participate if they made no reference to their sexuality, an offer that was rejected by the campaigners. FPP Radio News is brought to you by $6 Shirts. $6 Shirts is one of the top t-shirt companies on the web, and they want to be the t-shirt company for the Bitcoin marketplace. They actually give priority to all Bitcoin orders. Go look at their shirts. They're witty, hip, smart, and liberty-oriented. Shop $6 Shirts using my affiliate link, 6.fppradio.com, and help support FPP Radio News. That's 6.fppradio.com. The Associated Press reports the Washington Nationals used a small four-rotor drone to take publicity photos of players for a few days during spring training in Florida last month, but no one got the FAA's permission. A team official speaking